problems. I feel bad for you, son. I got 99 problems, but a bitch ain't one. I got the rat patrol on the cat patrol. Foes that want to make sure my cask is closed. Rap critics saves money, cash holes. I'm from the hood, stupid. What type of facts are those? If you grew up with hoes and you zap the toes, you celebrate the minute you was having dough. I'm like, fuck critics, you can kiss my whole asshole. If you don't like my lyrics, you can press fast forward. Got beef with radio if I don't play they show. They don't play my hits, well, I don't give a shit. So, rap mags try and use my black ass so advertisers could give them more cash for ads, fuckers. I don't know what you take me as or understand the intelligence that Jay-Z has. I'm from rags, the richest niggas, I ain't dumb.
I got 99 problems, but a bitch ain't one.
Hit me. 99 problems, but a bitch ain't one. If you having girl problems, I feel bad for you, son. I got 99 problems, but a bitch ain't one. Hit me. Yeah, it's 94 and my trunk is raw. And my rear view mirror is the motherfucking law. Got two choices, y'all. Pull over the car or bounce on the devil, put the pedal to the floor. And I ain't trying to see no highway chase with Jake. Plus, I got a few dollars, I can fight the case. So I pull over to the side of the road, I heard. Son, do you know why I'm stopping you for? Cause I'm young and I'm black and my hat's real low. Do I look like a mind reader, sir? I don't know. Am I under arrest or should I guess some more? Well, you was doing 55 in the 54. Lost in the registration and step out of the car. You carrying a weapon on you, I know a lot of you are. I ain't stepping out of shit, all my papers legit. Well, do you mind if I look around the car a little bit? Well, my glove compartment is locked, so it's the trunk in the back. And I know my rights, so you gon' need a warrant for that. Aren't you sharp to tack? You some type of law or something? Somebody important or something? I ain't passed the bar, but I know a little bit enough that you wanna legally search my shit. Well, we'll see how smart you are when the K-9 comes. I got 99 problems, but a bitch ain't one. Hit me! 99 problems, but a bitch ain't one. If you having girl problems, I feel bad for you, son. I got 99 problems, but a bitch ain't one. Hit me! 99 problems, but a bitch ain't one. If you having girl problems, I forgot for you, son. I got 99 problems, but a bitch ain't one. Hit me. Now, once upon a time, not too long ago, a nigga like myself had a strong arm, a hoe. And this is not a hoe in the sense of having a pussy, but a pussy having no goddamn sense, trying to push me. I try to ignore him, talk to the Lord, pray for him, but some fools just love to perform. You know the type, loud as a motorbike, but wouldn't bust a grape in a fruit fight. And only thing that's gonna happen is I'ma get the clapping, and he and his boys gonna be yapping to the captain. And there I go trapped in the Kit Kat again. Back through the system with the riffraff again. Fiends on the floor, scratching again. Paparazzis with their cameras snapping them. DA try to give a nigga shaft again. Half a mil for bail cause I'm African. All because the fool was harassing them. Trying to play the boy like he's saccharine. But ain't none sweet, but I hold my gun. I got 99 problems, being a bitch ain't one. Hit me! 99 problems, but a bitch ain't one. If you having girl problems, I feel bad for you, son. I got 99 problems, but a bitch ain't one. Hit me! 99 problems, but a bitch ain't one. If you having girl problems, I feel bad for you, son. I got 99 problems, but a bitch ain't one. Hit me! Got 99 problems and bitch ain't one. You crazy for this one, Rick? It's your boy.
Okay. Okay, so I was cruising around YouTube and I came across this song. And I figured we could play this song for this live stream. Okay, y'all?
No one told you life was gonna be this way. Your job's a joke. Yeah.
That was the theme song. Seems a millennia ago. It's all good. It's all gravy, baby. It's all gravy. How are y'all doing? How's everybody doing? Oh, I gotta turn that down. No, wait, no, desktop audio. No, we're good. All right, hold on. Let me get to Leon. I don't know if he's in the chat already or not. And he is. Hello, Leon. How are you? Leon, you're muted. Let me guess. You're in the bathroom.
No, no. I knew I muted myself. I just forgot to unmute. I cut my hand.
You cut your hand? What'd you cut your hand on?
I don't know. That's the crazy part.
Oh.
And it's like.
Is it a bad cut?
It's not a deep cut, but there's blood, so.
Mm.
Oh, well.
Well, I hope your hand is better.
I mean, it is. Can I just say something to the chat?
Yes. Go forth and talk to the chat.
Chat, there's going to be numerous times throughout this stream where I apologize to all of you for what I've done. I take full responsibility for what Tipster's become. I told him a period of months ago to just start making content about his opinions on things. And I thought he would just like throw out a bunch of dumbass conspiracy theories. And if nobody agreed, he'd be like, you know what? I don't care because I'm the big tip and all that. I didn't expect this. So, you know, it's my fault. My bad. My bad. I thought he was just going to kind of be like me. I didn't expect all this.
I mean, okay, listen, I don't care about the content change because, I knew he wanted to change content and he was happier doing that content, which I was absolutely for. I wasn't for him becoming friends basically with the enemy. And when I say the enemy, not just like, yeah, Keffels, but like what she stands for, what she's done. Like, she has done a lot. And it's like, bro. You know, and it's like, what?
Also, I still don't care that he's friends with Keffels. That has yet to bother me at all.
Yeah.
It's just the douche actions that he's been doing. It's like, you don't look cool. I saw a screenshot of him like being proud that he's trending with Keffels. But it's like, dude, you're trending because you look like somebody who's cheating on his wife. You don't look cool, my guy. And yeah. Also, I've been put on a leash. I can't really be as extreme as I would want to. One day, me and Xylie are going to be on my streams, and we're going to say whatever we want. And one last thing, Xylie.
Yes.
This goes directly to you.
Yes.
Congratulations on 6,000 subs.
Yay! Right? I'm so excited. I'm so happy.
You was like at 5'9 for about 8 months.
Dude, it kept going from 5'9 to 5'8. 5'9 to 5'8. As soon as I hit 5'9'1, I'd go down to 5'8'8. And then I go to 5'9'2 and then go down to 5'8'7. It was crazy.
Yeah.
It was absolutely crazy. I didn't think I was ever going to hit it. I'm so happy. But thank you. I appreciate that, sir.
Congratulations. Yeah, Xylie is so shocked that I've been quote-unquote good so far. It'll only get worse.
Yes, I am. Are you in the live so you can watch with me?
Yes.
Okay.
Have you seen any of this?
I have seen probably about 3/4 of it. So
for anyone who hasn't, all I'm gonna really say is,
oh wait, I gotta fix my screen.
All I'm gonna really say is the pinned comment under this video does not match anything that was actually said in this video at all. And the more you hear what is said in this video, the more you realize the pinned comment was complete damage control. Nothing but.
Really?
Because you said you only seen like 3/4 of it.
Yeah.
Everybody who watched this clip, I don't even know if, because I can't.
What's
I'm
the
not,
pinned comment?
It's Tipster.
All right, pinned comment by Tipster. Oh my.
Wait.
TLDR, dude.
TLDR. He uploads this clip. And maybe the live chat was more in agreement with Tipster, but the comments, 98% of it is criticizing him and Keffels. And he posted this pinned comment the morning after because everybody was watching this, was not giving him the benefit of the doubt. And he posted that as a cope.
Right.
And I wish I still had that song because I'd be playing it right now.
Rag, thank you for the 5 gifted memberships. I truly appreciate it. Thank you so much. Yes, 07's in the chat, please. Okay. Hello, everyone. I wanted to take a moment to provide some clarification regarding this conversation, as it seems my intentions with this have been misunderstood. First off, I wasn't upset about Bowblax leaking my DMs. It was less about the DMs and had more to do with the fact that I felt like by doing so, he was dragging me into a feud with him and Keffels, and I didn't appreciate that. I felt that was between the two of them, and it should be dealt between the two of them. Second, I felt like the whole thing between Keffels and Bowblax was a big misunderstanding, and I felt like them talking could easily resolve it when Bowblax told me she had him blocked so they couldn't have that conversation. I offered to bring her on if she was willing, which she was, and we did, and as expected, there were misunderstandings on both sides, and they were in the end resolved. Last thing I want to address is the whole she can make jokes but he can't argument. I'm not policing anyone's ability to make jokes. People are free to make whatever jokes they want. I was simply explaining to the person in the on the receiving end doesn't have to like those jokes, and that sometimes a joke can make someone uncomfortable. No one is saying who can or cannot make jokes, but it is important to understand that not everyone has to be okay with jokes you are making. Comedy is subjective, and sometimes something you might find funny, others won't. As a side note, I have reached out to Bowblax privately and apologized to him if the conversation came off as anything other than asking them to keep me out of their feud and trying to help the two of them resolve disagreement. My intentions here were never anything beyond that, and I am sincerely sorry if it came off any other way. Now, I have been on the internet long enough to know that most of you won't give a shit about this clarification and that you are just going to think whatever you want to think and feel however you want to feel about it. It is what it is. Oh my God, I'm so sick of that saying. And it is what it is. I'm still choosing to put it out there to make my position very clear. So what part of this was not real?
Now, that whole thing was posted hours after. That wasn't when he first dropped this clip. And everything in this is not what he was doing in that video. nor is it what he's doing after, because apparently he's still taking little sub tweet shots. He's retweeting shots from Keffels towards other people.
Mm-hmm.
Him trying to stay out of it, he's engaging with it. He's promoting it. He's adding his two cents. He's not staying out of it at all.
Did you see the Augie thing last night?
Oh, I loved every second of it.
Won't you say it even deeper there, buddy?
Oh, I loved every second of it. I especially love when Augie said, "My word."
Oh, God.
I'm not going to say it here because you police me.
I do not police you. You can say it.
Like, I'm what? In handcuffs, niggas.
You are not. Shut up. And you just said it, you asshole.
Well, yeah. I don't know if you gonna watch that. All I'm gonna say about that is it's weird how Tipster and Keffels will try so hard to sound like they're the smartest in the conversation, but everything they say is mirrored in hypocrisy, especially this stuff about jokes. Because he's saying all this about, oh, well, comedy is subjective this, and you need to understand how a person feels when you make these types of jokes. This motherfucker was endorsing those P-word jokes on Keemstar after this stream. So it's like, come on, bruh. You just went on this diatribe about understanding how people feel when it comes to jokes, and you making that joke?
Yeah. Well, here's my thing. It's almost like Tipster and I, we flip positions. It just took me longer to flip. Like, I used to be, you know, you've heard the stories a million times. I used to be the SJW. I used to be the tone policer. I used to be all that. Matter of fact, that's why me and Tipster didn't like each other at first.
That's why you and me don't like each other.
Shut up.
We're like an aunt and a nephew.
Yeah, we really are. We really are, to be honest. But no, it's like we flipped. Except for his, it just seems like to me his is like overnight. Like mine was like probably like a year. I would say a year coming. The more serious subjects I started covering, the more I cared more about that than tone policing people. You know, it was stuff like that that it just. It doesn't seem genuine to me, and I don't, you know, like, I'm not trying to jump on the train, because I was one of the last ones to hop off, or hop on, or whatever you want to say. You know, I was one of the last ones holding out, and that joke did it for me, dude. That joke did it for me.
I think you were the last one.
I think I was the last one.
Because when he did the fake... oh, me and Keffels are beefing thing, and then he did that dumbass tweet about, I'm taking a break, my mental health is not fine, and he came back 20 minutes later. I was like, all right, douchebag, you're done. Like, if you're gonna fake beef for attention, you're done.
I do have to give it to everybody, though, because nobody gave me a hard time being the last one on Tipster. No one actually ever gave me a hard time, and I even told him that no one's giving me a hard time being the last one. You know, it's just, I don't know, man. Like, at some level, I'm pissed. And at some level, I have to admit, I'm still kind of hurt. Crying hurt? No. So you're not going to get any fucking tears tonight, people, okay? So whoever was betting on whether they're going to see tears, you're going to fucking lose, all right? Just know that for a fact, okay?
Hipster lied, Xylie cried was the funniest thing I saw.
Fuck you.
It was like, why did y'all make that rhyme?
Oh my God, because they're assholes. That's why. They're assholes in this community. But no, I mean, but I have to admit, I'm still kind of hurt.
It's fair to be hurt. Like, that's somebody you consider a friend, and they doing scummy shit. And it's not even really scummy. It's just douchey. Like, what you trying to get attention? And then you celebrating how you're trending on Twitter, yet when I scroll through Twitter, it's a bunch of people just with screenshots of you being creepy and somehow finding other women's social media accounts without any form of background.
Yeah.
Like, that's what you want to trend for?
Yeah.
The fuck?
I don't get it. All right, let's go ahead and start this. I'm going to put it at 1.25, okay?
All right, Chad. All right. She's about to go down right now. Oh, boy. What's going on?
All right.
So, you're mad, and I'm a bit mad too. So okay. Who's gonna explain the madness first?
I just don't understand why you're leaking my DMs when you're in an argument with Keffels. If you like have a problem with Keffels, that's cool, dude. But like,
okay, hold on. Let me put the volume up on this a little bit. My bad.
Oh, I didn't know if that was for me or the chat. I heard it fine.
I'm just looking at my screen and it doesn't.
Between you two. What's the problem? Like, why are you leaking my shit?
Because you said that okay, Keffels has good. Changed and you said that Keffels was just trolling and doesn't actually think I'm like transphobic or whatever.
Yeah, on that
and
specific then
she jumps
day, I didn't,
on
that
she
specific
jumps
day.
On the opportunity to fucking get a 4-year-old tweet
so,
on a parody account
so
where nothing
has to do with
serious.
Me, bro. What the fuck does that have to do with me? Why are you leaking my shit in regards to a conversation on a completely different fucking day?
Okay, wait a minute. He sounds pretty mad that he dropped the DMs.
I mean, Bowblax did say, I think it was even before, like a few minutes before, Tipster was saying like he's upset and he's mad and he wants to bring Bowblax on. I don't know why that part was left out. So that's the first lie. Yeah. He was mad.
Yeah, he was mad. Okay, hold on. All right, there we go. Much clearer. Much clearer. It was on 480. You know what's funny? And I hope Tipster hears this. You know what's funny, Tipster?
Yes, Xylie.
Okay, all right, you'll play Tipster, fine.
Lamau.
I have been asked by so many people to leak the DMs between me and him. And I have fucking refused.
The fuck?
And I'm not going to release them. Why? Because I don't see the point. You're already showing what you did. You're already showing what you did. Why do I have to release them? You know? It's... Bro. This whole shit is just... It's amazing to me.
And can I add, have you seen the newer developments that happened at like 3 o'clock in the morning?
We're not at 3 o'clock in the morning. What newer developments?
So, apparently, he was just nuking Discord messages with everybody.
Oh, yes. I was one of the messages that he nuked. I went into my DMs. I went into my DMs with him, and it's just me.
Yeah. See,
like,
I don't
damn,
have.
Bro, were you scared? Were you scared that I was going to drop DMs between me and you? No, I wasn't going to do that. I'm not going to do that unless it's absolutely necessary. I would never do that unless it was absolutely necessary. I have people asking for our DMs now, and I still haven't dropped them. But yet you're going to delete everything? So you must think I'm scummy. Or are you worried about what you put in there? Because what you put in there wasn't bad. If I thought it was bad, I wouldn't be your fucking friend.
There's another thing. Like, he's going around celebrating like he got this big dub. What you deleting stuff for? Like, what you running from, necessarily? Like, especially with people you have, like, personal conversations with. Something we should know?
Maggot, I know the cum zone is real, because I was in there for, like, 5 minutes.
Okay, that's another thing. Because people were trying to figure out, whoa, that's so weird, it's the cum zone. As somebody who was in that Discord, it was just a name.
It was just a name, that's all it is. But I wasn't in there. I wasn't in there very long. Thank you, Brad, for joining the Just Saying Squad. I appreciate it.
I was.
Yeah. I mean, you were in there when they were laughing about me falling for that one joke. That fake fight.
Not the Keffels thing. The thing with
not the Keffels
the lolly.
Thing. Yeah. With rum.
Because he had to come. Yeah, it was like. I was shocked that people were like, what? He really does? Have y'all not seen his streams where he's like, we're the Coomer Nation and he plays that sound? I don't know who Beavers is, but I hope the worst for him because he said I got cummed on.
Okay, Beavers is Beavers. Just go with it when it comes to Beavers. All right, let's go.
Because it relates to the situation.
No, it doesn't. This is a completely different conversation on a completely different disagreement you guys had.
Wait, it's about Keffels thinking I'm transphobic.
Well, yeah, because she sees, like, the recent tweets that you've made, the other stuff that came out, and she's, like, changed her mind. Like, okay, maybe I think he is transphobic. Do I agree with that? No, I think you're, like, just being, like, edgy fucking tweeting or whatever. But, like, that's how she feels about it.
Why? What? That's insane.
I mean, you literally have a tweet on your alt account where you're talking about, like, trans women aren't real women, but you'd still fuck the shit out of them. What is she supposed to think about?
It's a joke tweet, and right under that...
Cat's meow. Thank you for joining Just Saying Squad.
I said I can understand that you're saying it's a joke, but like you can understand why she would be upset about it, right?
No, I can't, because we've had in-depth conversations about trans allyism in DMs and stuff like that, and she's just fucking going out of her way to attack me for no reason. She wants me to be transphobic.
That's the thing about Keppels. Keppels is like, I can do it, but you can't. What about that tweet that she made about getting autistic women by the trains and go look at the trains and that's how I can get pussy? I mean, Keffels, really? You can make jokes like that though, right? Get the fuck out of here. Get the fuck out of here. She's fucking edgy.
Patient with her about it. Why do you gotta drag me into this shit?
Because you dragged yourself into the shit when you went into my DMs and said that Keffels is just trolling and doesn't
because
think
she was
I'm
just trolling you that day. You're trying to conflate a completely different conversation that happened back in May with something that's happening now. That was
because they're directly related.
They're not though. It's two completely different conversations.
Dude, that was on May 29th. That was 14 days ago. It was 2 weeks ago. It's not like it was 2 months ago. It was 2 weeks ago.
About me being transphobic?
She literally told me that day that she was trolling you. That's why I told you she was trolling
okay,
you.
Okay, and now you know what upset. Else it relates to? I'm trolling her on my parody account, and now she thinks that's legit, even though... But she's allowed to troll that I'm transphobic. Like, what? Like, why can she troll, but I can't?
I'm just frustrated because, like, I'm getting dragged into this, and it doesn't have anything to do with me. If you have a disagreement with Keffels, deal with it with fucking Keffels, dude. Hello?
Okay.
So if you have a problem with Keffels, deal with it with Keffels. I don't understand why you have to...
Oh, wait, Xylie.
Because...
Yeah.
Keep that last part in mind about joking that Bowblax is transphobic.
Okay.
Because it comes... I believe it either comes up later in this video or in the Augie stream. She actually was serious about calling him transphobic.
Because you're upset with her.
Because we were talking about her and it's directly related to her. I don't think you would mind me showing DMs of you defending your friend. What?
I don't know, dude.
What's so bad about what's in the DMs? Are you embarrassed about what you said in the DMs?
No, there's nothing I'm embarrassed about in those DMs. I just don't understand why you're leaking them.
I explained to you why.
Well, I don't think that that's a good reason. That's what I'm saying.
Okay, then I'm sorry.
So he is mad that he leaked the DMs. He is, in fact, mad that he leaked the DMs, which, okay, I can kind of understand. I don't believe in leaking DMs unless you absolutely have to. Unless it's a situation where somebody's saying I'm lying and I feel like I need to show, it has to be an exact reason why. I'm not going to just willy-nilly leak DMs. I mean, I don't want it done to me, so I don't do it to other people, you know what I mean?
You should see the Xylie Leon DMs.
Yeah, it's usually me cussing you out.
Basically.
Yeah.
My reason.
I don't know, dude. So now what?
I don't know. Do you want me to, like, delete the tweets or whatever?
No, I mean, it's already out there, dude, so, like, there's no point to it.
I mean, I just didn't think you would mind about me leaking something you would say publicly
anyway. Maybe you should have asked me first.
Okay, then that's my bad. I should have asked you first. Okay.
Okay, fair enough. All right. I don't know. That's all I really had to say. I didn't like being dragged into it. Like, I understand that not everybody gets along.
Thank you, Beavers. Beavers said, I'd never leak Xylie DMs. Thank you, Beavers, with the heart. I appreciate it. Beavers is a good guy sometimes. Thank you,
Beavers. Is Bonnie telling me she'll ascend if I leak our DMs? I don't think Bonnie realizes we haven't spoken probably since last year.
And don't worry, Bonnie, you won't be hidden in this chat. I saw what happened to you in Augie's chat last night. They snuffed her out last night.
They did.
They snuffed her out, boy. It was funny as hell. Oh, they only timed you out. They didn't hide you. Okay, well, see. Okay, so you got a little smack on the hand. I get you.
With Keffels, I get that not everybody likes her, and that's cool, dude. Like, I have no problem being friendly.
I don't even dislike Keffels up until today. I've been very nice to her.
Well, you can see
in
how
DMs
like those,
and everywhere.
You can understand how
I've
those
been extreme.
Tipster, why don't people like Keffels? Why don't people like Keffels? I'll read the exact reason why people don't like Keffels. Excuse me. Wait a moment. Because I've read it before, and I'll read it again. I'll tell you the exact reason why people don't like Keffels. And it's actually the shorter list and not the longer list. And we can add more shit to it today. The reason why people don't like Keffels, as told by Xylie. 100K, trip to Ireland, deplatforming people who said the mildest things, calling people transphobic who just said the mildest things, lying about her dox, and doxing people and places. And that's the short list. That's the short list.
Extremely nice to her.
You can understand how those tweets, now that like everybody knows that you're alt and like you're talking about like, what the fuck did that account say? You can understand how those tweets would be kind of sexually harassing in nature, right?
Oh, but her going into Bowblax's DM showing a gif of her jiggling her tits isn't sexually harassing though, right? That's not sexually harassing at all, is it?
And the reason it's not is the dumbest I've ever heard. I'm trying to connect with you, so I'm going to send you a gif of me bouncing my tits.
Eva is in my chat saying, let me write this down. I need to tell my therapist. Eva! Eva!
It's not the fact that Keffels was saying that dumbass shit. It's the fact that the whole time, Tipster's co-signed it. It is like, what? You spent all this time telling Bowblax, oh, you need to understand how she feels when you make these types of jokes because it's offensive and it hurts her. Yet when Bowblax tells you he's uncomfortable with being sent boobs, it's just, oh, it's a meme, it's a Sonic gif. Like, come on now.
Yeah.
What was the phrase? Jiggle physics? It's just jiggle physics. Like, stop.
Yeah, no, I agree. I agree 100% with you. I totally agree.
Because that's what she got upset about.
They're jokes, and it's not right, real. She knows I don't want
to. It doesn't mean she has to be comfortable with it.
How does that hurt like, her if she knows that it's not
You can joke about
real.
Whatever you want, but it doesn't mean she has to be comfortable with it. Like, you understand that,
And
right?
I'm not comfortable with her fucking sending her jiggling tits in my DMs, but I wasn't freaking out calling her fucking autistic chaser, even though she
speaks
about wanting to fuck
about
autistics
that.
All
so
time.
So again, talk to her about that. If you have a problem with it, talk to her about it.
Why didn't she talk to me about it instead of fucking going on her Twitter and blasting me as a transphobe to 100,000 people?
Yeah.
Exactly.
Why are you more mad at me?
There you go.
And you see how he deflects to, oh, talk to her about it. Like, why are you pressing him for something you could press Keffels about for the same thing? Like, because, Xylie, maybe I don't know you enough.
Okay.
But if I was just running around saying things about certain people, pretty sure you would check me on that.
I would. I'm going to be honest with you. If I saw you say something that was like, sometimes you say edgy shit and I'm like, but, you know, it's not that big of a deal, right? But if you said something like completely outlandish, whether it be like even racist or sexist or transphobic or anything like that, yes, I would check you. I'd go straight into your DMs going, what the fuck is wrong with you? Have you bumped your motherfucking head? Yes,
and
I would.
And the reason Xylie's never done it is either because she agrees or she just doesn't see it.
Yeah, probably.
Because I made a reference to a certain body part looking like a cow's mouth, and I got nothing from Xylie. I wasn't even trying to poke at Xylie. It's just, she doesn't see the majority of what I tweet.
I probably didn't see it, because if I would have seen it, I probably would have said something. Going, excuse, listen, perfect example. This Bowblax parody account, I sent the link to that account to Bowblax in the DMs, and I went, sir, in little letters, and then dot, dot, dot. And then I went, sir, in all capital letters with like 3 exclamation points. And he's like, what? I was like, the account, Bobby. And he's like, LOL.
I mean.
Because some of that shit that account was saying, I'm like, bro, I understand you were making edgy jokes, but bro.
What is called throbbing horse
cock? It's called throbbing horse cock. God damn it.
Oh, and as the only black person around, I endorse the Bowblax BLM song. And if you're white complaining about that song, I have credence to call you.
You know
a
what?
Racist.
I complained to that song about Tipster. That's why me and Tipster didn't like each other at first. He hated me after that conversation I had with him about that BLM song. Because I was doing a series on a particular creator that doesn't shut up about Tipster. And Tipster was on his show and he played him the BLM song. And I was with two friends And the one friend that knew Tipster messaged Tipster and going, what the fuck is this? Why are you laughing at this? And this was during SJW days, shit like that. And we got in a call with Tipster, me and my two friends. And it seemed like it was a good conversation. Well, come to find out, Tipster was pissed with me after that. And that's why Tipster hated me for so long. And then he started, what do you call it? Hate watching me. Because remember how he always threw in my face, you know, in a joking manner. He would always throw in my face in a joking manner that there's no good Latinos in the commentary community. He would always throw that in my face because I used to say it. There's no good Latinos in the commentary community.
I actually don't remember that
at
all.
Yeah. Yeah. I didn't know if you were around when I told that story. But yeah.
Mm-hmm. I'm still not around. I don't fester in this.
That's no, just, I'm talking about around and like in my streams, not everywhere. I'm talking about my streams. And you do come to my streams, but I don't think you came to my streams when I was telling that story, though, maybe.
You know, I'm not even going to get into the whole thing about commentary community.
But I just think funny. My point is it's funny that song has come back around when that was the exact, he was defending that song. He was defending Bowblax doing that song to me. He was defending that. That's my point. You see what I'm saying?
Bowblax hates the Blacks, man.
Me than her.
Because you're involved.
Beavers, say that one more time and you're gonna be putting time out for 5 minutes.
Say the word, I'm ready.
Being me and shit that has nothing to do with me. This is between you and
she
her.
She involved you by like quote tweeting you and getting you involved in all this shit.
I don't know. It just kind of seems... Okay, what were you
it's
saying?
It's insane to me that, like, Keffels is literally, like, lying about me in front of, like, thousands of people and trying to hit me when I'm down when I've done nothing to her. And so you're more mad at me.
Yeah, because I don't want to be involved in this shit. That's why.
Then why did you get involved by DMing me about it?
You know what? I don't believe that. And the reason why I don't believe that, because he himself has been taking pot shots at people in the commentary community.
Yes. Also... if you don't want to be involved, you could have easily like ended this stream on whatever topic you was talking about and went to into a Discord call with Bowblax. But you decided to bring it on your live stream?
True. That's very
nobody, true. Nobody outside of anybody in that Discord call would have been any the wiser about it. As a motorcycle just wants to be loud through my window.
I know, so Sierra. Like, I watched Tommy C's video today. I think he's doing it on purpose. I think he's doing all this on purpose. I think he's doing all this on purpose to burn bridges to know he's not coming back.
Are you telling me, Xylie, that this is a grift?
Okay. Honestly, okay. I can see where people are saying it's a grift. I can understand their logic in saying that. I don't know if I want to go so far to say it's a grift. What I think has happened, okay? And I'm not trying to be funny when I say this. Please know I'm not trying to be sarcastic when I say this. What I think has happened is he has found people that will not give him the amount of shit that he got in the commentary community. And he feels safe. And he is doing... the content and taking the takes that they have to fit in over there. That's what I think is happening. I don't know if it's necessarily a grift.
I didn't think it was a grift at first, but when I saw him last night talking about how, oh, I'm trending, haha, haters mad. It's like, you trending, you bragging about it, you not elaborating on why you trending, and you nuking your Discords and servers again. My buddy, that's grifting tactics right there. And grifters do that when they caught.
See, I look more at... okay, so I look at more like pearly fangs and like the red pills and the manosphere. I look at that more like grifting because they're actually... they're actually saying shit, working on people's insecurities, but specifically men's insecurities and shit, and they get a lot of money for it. So I look at that more like grifting.
Agreed.
I look more at, like, have a seat with Chris Hansen. I look more at Chris Hansen like grifting. I don't know if Tipster is specifically grifting. And you know what I'm saying? Like, I don't see him doing that. Like, I don't know if I would call it that. I can see where people may be thinking that, but I don't know if I feel comfortable enough to call it grifting.
Yeah. And this is where I'm coming from with it. He's nuking things after getting embarrassed and exposed for being a hypocrite. And in my mindset, I'm just going to stand and firm in what I'm saying. And if I realize, oh, wait, I'm getting called out.
But you know what? Tipster's always done that. Do you know how many private discords Tipster has been through? You know how many private discords I have been given invites to? Because he always ends up nuking it when he gets pissed.
Probably like the same amount as me.
Probably. If not, probably more for you because you've known him longer.
Because I don't think I've known him longer.
I think you have, actually.
Like, and even like he would be in all these different issues and he'd nuke all these servers.
Yeah.
And then make a new one and then invite me. And I just be like, what's up? What's going on?
Yeah, see, that's the thing. That's why I don't know if I call it a grift because he's always done that. Now, I don't know about the Discord DMs. He ain't never deleted them with me before. But, you know, like the deleting Discords and stuff like that, he's always done that. So I don't know. True. I don't know to call it a grift because he's always done that. That's like a normal thing for him.
God damn it. I'm going to say it. And I know Xylie's gonna roll her eyes at me.
All right.
Fucking BX Beast Boys, right?
Oh, oh God, my heart.
I'll give the devil his due.
You said that shit on Twitter, and all I could do to muster up was just a finger going up. That's the only thing. I believe that's what I put under that tweet when you said that. I liked it, and I just did a finger going up because I couldn't muster anything.
I'll give the devil his due.
Oh God.
He's still an anti-SJW, but I'll give the devil his due.
Bro, you know what? Those are words that I thought I would never agree with. Those are words I thought I'd never agree with.
Would they say broken clocks right once a day?
Well, something I will like say that. This. One of my ex-friends was right about him also. And I made that tweet today, and, one of my ex-friends and person that I am friendly with now, I sent it to them, and I said, listen, y'all were right, you know? I gotta give them their due. They were right.
I ain't never shy at eating crow once in a while.
Hey, you got to. That's life, you know?
You DM'd me being like, oh, she's trolling. She doesn't actually think you're transphobic.
Bowblax, like, I'm sorry. I don't know if this is your autism, but that was a completely different day. That was a day where she literally told me herself that she was trolling you. She's not trolling today because she's mad today.
And I'm trolling her today.
Well, she's clearly upset about
it. So what's the difference? And I was clearly upset at that.
So why didn't you say anything then? Like, I thought you guys talked about it.
We did. We did talk about it. And she said, I didn't think you were a transphobe. And then all of a sudden, out of the blue, she starts calling me a transphobe for a random parody tweet that I made 4 years ago of something even 4 years ago.
So talk to her about it then. Or don't.
I can. Like, I'm blocked. She blocked me. What do you mean? She blocked me the second she saw that tweet. How can I talk to her about it?
I don't know what to tell you then. I mean, I can tell her that if you're interested in talking, I can tell her that you want to talk. But like, otherwise, like, I don't know what to say.
And he could have set, and you're right, he could have set that talk offline.
Hey, but he didn't want to be involved.
Yeah.
Okay, but you're still mad at me more than Keffels.
I was only mad because I was asking you, why'd you leak my DMs? You explained it to me.
He says right there he was mad about the DMs. But, wait a minute. Nah.
I told you, you're going to be doing this for a while.
First off, I wasn't upset about Bowblax leaking my DMs. Bro.
Xylie, I'm just gonna let you know right now, you're gonna be pausing and going right back to this pinned comment a few more times.
Oh my god.
Ooh, so boy.
why.
You explained it to me, and I'm still not happy about it, but, like, it's whatever.
But at least you understand the reason. At least you understand the reason. I'm not trying to be malicious. I'm trying to defend myself against
slander. Yeah, I mean, I guess I understand the reason. I'm not happy about it still, but it just kind
of
is what it is.
Well, I do feel bad, that, because, like, I didn't think you would mind, and I should have asked you, of course, but, like...
Yeah, if you're going to leak shit,
I don't know, but, yeah, of course.
I don't go around leaking
shit. There we go. I'm apologize for that, but, like... This shit with Keffels is absolutely just ridiculous. Like, she's out to get me, bro.
Yeah, I don't know.
Like, how can... After all the conversations I've had with her in DMs about trans issues and a whole video I made defending her and a bunch of all this shit I've always said about trans people and how much I care about this issue.
JoeMega499, Tipster lost all the sympathy from me as soon as he weaponized Bowblax autism. Snaky, manipulative as fuck.
With, like, human rights and everything. Thank you. I care a lot about it. And then, like, one little fucking account leaks that's, like, a complete troll. It's called Throbbing Horsecock. And then she just says I'm transphobic off.
What were you doing that got leaked, too? Like, what were you doing?
I was just... I just switched my Twitter account, and it was on there. You do realize... If you scroll down, I've only tweeted on it 2 times in the last 3 years prior to
getting leaked. Yeah, I saw it.
It's it's, like, completely random. And you got... And it's just so fucked up that Keffels would just be, like... Oh, he's transphobic. And then block me, too. Not even talk to me about it. Block me. You talk about me not talking to you with the DM leak, and I guess, like, because there was nothing incriminating in the DMs, I didn't think it was an issue, but that's my bad, of course, and I apologize. But, like, she fucking just blocked me and then outed me, and then when I troll back a little bit, in the same way she trolled with me in DMs and on Twitter with the transphobic shit, right? Just trolling. In the same way she does with me, I didn't think she'd see it as sexual harassment, because it's literally the same shit she says to me, right?
I mean, has she told... what is the tweet? Let me bring up the fucking account.
She said she want... She... Bowblax can, like, fucking blow backs, and then she's like, yeah, look at my jiggling tits and shit like that.
I mean, I saw the DM. She didn't
Oh, there's Femyaz right there. Tipster, can I please moderate this discussion? This is generally hurt to listen to. Femyaz, we heard you on Augie.
And let me
tell you, you were hard to listen to. Just saying.
All right. Can I segue this just a little bit?
Yes, please. Go for it.
So, the bio of this spam Twitter account, greatest thing ever. I endorse Bowblax. He's welcome to the barbecue any day of the week. Second, this Femyaz dude.
I am Femyaz. I am here to debate you.
The whole Augie thing, which you didn't watch? Or
I did watch. I'm choosing not to go over it.
Okay, so for anyone who didn't watch, Augie, Nick, Tipster, Keffels, all talking. I think Keemstar comes in at one point.
Yeah.
Everybody leaves. And then all of a sudden, Jalen comes in and Femyaz comes in.
Oh, my God.
And you ain't never seen a group of people just talk about something expecting everybody else in the call to care. They came in after getting into a conversation about policing jokes on Twitter and hypocrisy, trying to talk to Augie about trans kids. And I'm sorry, I hold the same sentiment as Augie. Nobody cares. That wasn't what anybody was talking about.
I'm going to be honest with you. I thought that was bunk. I really did. It sounded just like bunk.
Who's bunk?
Oh, bunk is they... are a political person. They do, like, political, like, debates and stuff like that. Bunk's a sweetie. I love Bunk. But I thought Femyaz was Bunk. I really did. It sounded just like Bunk. Oh, Magadez, Bunk is my son.
And it's like, I like how when I say things line up for me. I did a video, I think now would be 2 days ago, where I said, I don't hate transgenders. I hate trans activists because they do nothing but embarrass transgenders. And coincidentally, these idiots go into a Discord call and completely embarrass themselves for no reason. So it's like, thank you for proving my point.
All right, let's keep going.
The fucking account is called Throbbing Horsecock, dude. It's like... Like, oh, and all the tweets on it have always been, like, over...
I'll never get over
that
name.
She was making it a big deal, so I wanted to, like, tone it down and put it back to joke category and, like, play the character pretending that, like, she's hot. Well, you know, I'm not personally attracted to her, but, like, you know, the character just goes ham, dude. Okay. And I don't see it as sexual harassment necessarily, because it's like...
Okay, Bobby, just say she can get it, okay? Just say she can get it. Come on now.
She knows that I don't want to fuck her. Like, she knows the context around everything in the account. It's just fucking around. Like, when she said she wants to fuck autistic people on her
account.
But again, she trolls too.
But again, you can understand how this might make her uncomfortable, right? When you're talking about, damn, Keffel Sticks, she's one of the real ones for sure. Or you're like quote tweeting me, back off, Tubby. She needs a real 9-incher right now. Like, you can understand how that might make someone uncomfortable, right?
She went into his DMs with jiggling tits. But that's okay, though, bro, right? Right, for $2. As one of the tips mods, he really showed a snaky side. Oh, my God. So, like, okay, let me ask. Everybody in the chat who are mods of Tipster, did y'all start rioting or something?
Okay, so as a now former mod, because I've been unmodded after blocking Tipster.
Okay.
Nobody rioted. It was kind of just like a bunch of people kind of just sitting watching the stream. It was the comments when the clip got posted as a video. That's when shit hit the fan for old Tipster. Oh, never mind. Echo says she was rioting.
As a mod of Tipster, I was rioting. Oh, okay. Squatson said, what about comments like that to your goth mommy's Tipster? Is that not harassment? Well, here's the thing about the goth mommy thing. The reason why I never looked at it as harassment, okay, first of all, that's why I always told him, don't you call me a goddamn goth mommy. Don't you fucking do that. And I would never join his channel because of what the titles were, right? But you know what? Most of them goth mommies were all for being a goth mommy. They were like, I'm top goth mommy. I'm a goth mommy. I'm a top goth mommy. Okay? So those chicks were totally okay being called goth mommies. So I'm not going to put that as, like, I understand what you're saying, Squatchin'. Don't get me wrong. Okay? Do not get me wrong. I understand what you're saying. Because that could be taken as harassment also. That's why I was like, you're not going to call me no damn goth mommy. I'll be damned. But they were all for it. They were all for being one of Tipster's goth mommies. That's why I told his ass. Y'all, you need to,
sure. Yo, and I mean,
that's really what's happening here. Is she like saw these?
Wait, Joe Mega what?
Oh, you didn't see it?
Uh-uh. What did Joe Mega say?
I'm not repeating it.
Joe Mega, I'm going to tell you what. You about to sit down for 5 minutes. Bowblax, thank you for the raid. Bowblax.
Bowblax.
And if you want to hop in, you can. We're in the Mudslingers.
Bowblax. You good in my book, bro. You can say the word. You can say the N-word anytime.
Oh, God.
You invited to the barbecue, my boy.
Thank you for the raid. Thank you. Echo a tragedy, 9-inch raid. Lord have mercy. Oh.
Shout out to my 9 inches out there.
Yeah, everybody who's member, spam mayo for Bowblax. Everybody who's a member, spam that mayo for Bowblax. We'll just have to let Skip, we'll have to let Bowblax share Skip's mayo.
These tweets where you're talking about giving her a 9-incher, it made her uncomfortable.
Well, it isn't me. It's, oh my God. It's supposed to.
It is you, but you're doing it as a character.
Yeah, I don't actually have a 9-incher or want to fuck her. And she knows that. Like, why can't, and she's a troll too. Like, if this was like someone who was super serious all the time, like she started beef with me and then I decided to troll a little back like she just did with me last month.
But the thing you have to understand about jokes is like, yeah, you can make whatever jokes you want, but like the recipient of the joke doesn't always have to like it. Right?
Okay.
Like, you guys have made jokes that I don't fucking like. I mean, obviously.
Yeah, and you've made jokes that other people don't like, and they've
And I do agree. All right. Jokes are subjective. I do agree with that point. All right. Because some of the jokes y'all make sometimes, I just look at y'all like y'all have lost your fucking mind. For real. Like, bro. Just say.
And that's DMs, like, goth mommy can get it or whatever.
Yeah, so I mean, and that's fine. I'm just saying, like, that's where she's coming from. She didn't appreciate
it. I understand why she's upset.
But see, my problem is she makes the same kind of jokes. She makes the same kind of jokes. She makes edgy jokes all the time, so it's okay for her to be edgy, but no one else can. You're literally tone policing people. She can make edgy jokes about autists, but get the fuck out of here. I mean, come on, dude. She can make those edgy jokes all she wants, but stupid. Fucking stupid.
I'm upset at her for calling me a transphobe and, like, doubling and tripling down.
Okay, well, you...
And then my response is to make a joke. Isn't that a better response than, like, going ham on my main and calling her a piece of shit?
I mean, didn't you kind of...
Me joking back on an alt account with, like, barely any followers? Isn't that, like, a better alternative?
Keffel sending random unsolicited DMs about blowing out backs and sending... So, like, you did call her out, though.
Yeah, afterwards.
But you did eventually call
you
her.
You noticed he had him muted, right? Call her out, did you notice that?
Like, a better alternative?
Mm-hmm. I mean, didn't you kind of...
Me joking back on an alt...
See where it says this tweet account you muted, and then he hit view?
Alt account with, like, barely any followers? Tweet. Isn't that, like, a better alternative?
Keffel sending random unsolicited DMs about...
He had Bowblax muted. Which I knew he muted. I knew he muted people. I knew he blocked Nick. But I knew he muted a bunch of people. I didn't know Bowblax was one of them, though.
Blowing out backs and sending... So, like, you did call her out, though.
Yeah, afterwards.
But you did eventually call her out.
Yeah, so, because she kept pushing and saying I'm sexually harassing her. First she calls me a transphobe, then she says I'm sexually harassing her. Of course, after a while, I'm gonna, like, push back. Mm-hmm. And what did I do for her to start going after me? Make a tweet when I didn't even know she existed on an alt account with no followers.
Yeah, I don't know.
So, like, I mean, I guess you can decide who's,
I just think this is between you two, and, like, I can tell her if you want to talk to her that you're willing to talk, but, like, that's it. This is not between you, me, and her. This is just...
I mean, clearly she's just being, like, disingenuous because she knows my feelings on trans people. I've talked about it. I'm, like, so openly pro-trans in every way, and just to take this little thing and just diminish it, it's just, like... It's fucked up. She knows what she's doing, and I don't respect her.
She does know what she's doing, and I do agree with him. She knows what she's doing. She knows she is helping Tipster burn that bridge. And I honestly believe, in her mind, she's helping, and I believe this is my opinion, bitch, so don't come for me, okay? But I believe, in her mind, she's helping him destroy his connections to the commentary community to get him away from it. I believe that. Some people believe that she is trying to get into the commentary community. I think she's trying to get Tipster out and just on her side because he has a nice whopping 100,000 subs.
All right. I got a question. When we speak about this community, what are we talking about? Because the way I
basically the commentary bros. In other words, get Tipster away from Bowblax, Augie, and Nick. Basically.
So when I hear that, and I keep hearing, oh, I left the commentary community, and then I realize he's talking about like 3 to 5 people. Can't you just say you just stop talking to people?
But you still have like offshoot channels. Like I'm an offshoot channel. Funny enough, it's because of Tipster I got into this. I mean, in the sense of I wanted to do when I first started watching commentary content, I used to like the way Tipster did it, and that's when he did more videos and live streams. And then I started watching Augie, and I like how he did the live stream, because I've always been a live streamer. I was a live streamer on Mixer, right? And I wanted to do what Tipster was doing, but like Augie in the sense of live streaming it. That's not how I got into the community, but that's how I started covering commentary. I got into the community through Willie Mac.
That's another white guy who's invited to the barbecue.
I love me some Willie Mac. That's my number one. That's my day one commentary bro right there. I love me some Willie Mac. Matter of fact, he and I are going after the same people in the manosphere. We're like on sync with each other with it. So, yeah.
And that's okay, fine. Fair like, enough. She blocked me and I blocked her. It's done.
Fair enough. That's
She's
it,
a piece
then.
Of shit, in my opinion. But
okay.
I do apologize for... leaking the DMs. So, yeah.
Okay. Cats, that wasn't commentary community.
I didn't mean anything malicious towards you by it.
Nice try, though.
I was just saying, like, she by her... Maybe I should have...
I just get genuinely frustrated. I'm gonna give it to you 100 right now. And I'm not necessarily saying you're doing this. But, like, it just seems like anytime, like, Keffels does anything, everybody looks at me like, well, what are you gonna say about it, Tipster? What are you gonna do about it, Tipster? And I'm not her fucking daddy. So it's like... I don't understand this, like, bullshit of, like, anytime Keffels says anything or does anything, people dislike. It's like, well, Tipster, what do you got to say about it? Like, it's annoying. And that's why I look at this situation, I'm like, okay.
So if that's the case, why are you having this conversation on a live stream?
I agree. But you know what, though? You know what? Tipster can't talk. Tipster used to do the same thing for the commentary bros. I used to joke when I used to not like the commentary community, all right? Because I fed into the bullshit that they were all racist and all this and all this and all this. You know, all the phobics and all the is, okay? I used to joke saying that Tipster was like the first tank. If anybody ever said anything bad about Bowblax, Augie, or Nick, Tipster was the first one fighting them. The exact same thing he's doing with Keffels, Tipster used to do with those three. The exact same thing. I specifically remember him doing that. The exact same thing that he's doing for Keffels now. Meowser, thank you for being a member for 10 months. Like, you know?
Hey, I can't, like, not say anything anymore, all right? Because it just happens every fucking time. Keffels says or does something that people don't like, and then I'm the one that gets dragged into it. It's not my problem. Well, I don't police what she says.
You fuck no, buddy, because now every time she breathes, it's over for you.
It's crazy. But she loves it, though. She loves it. I'm telling you now, she fucking loves it.
I was bringing it up as an example of her saying she's not trolling when she... Or she is trolling, but I can't troll. Yeah. But maybe I should have brought up a different example. I just didn't think you would mind, but that's my bad, and I should have asked you first. All right?
Yeah. It's all right, man. It's good. But you can understand my frustration with that, right?
The yeah, same thing can you understand mine?
Yeah, I can. The Thank same thing you. Happened with, like, the AP thing, right? Like, when she did the whole stupid telling her kid to say the N-word thing. Like, a bunch of people looked at me like, well, are you going to say something? It's like, well, I wasn't even there.
Yeah, because you welcomed her back. Tipster should have X'd that bitch as soon as she dropped what she dropped and tried to halfway me to your ass. You should have fucking dropped her. But you didn't. And you took her back in and you brought her back into the community. Because her ass was fucking toast until you brought her back in.
That happened. Tipster needs to take responsibility for his whores.
Like, again, I get that everybody doesn't like Keffels, and I get that people aren't happy with the fact that I'm friends with Keffels, but the reality is we're friends, and that's not changing.
Okay, I'm fine with that. So now I'm looking at her DMs, and she says, because we did have a little bit of a conversation from, like, the May thing with the transphobe, she said, sad you can't give me a fair shake. What?
Fuck you. I'm not giving you a fair shake. Now, granted, you probably don't want to talk to me because I only have 6K, all right? So I'm not relevant enough for you to try to slime your way into my DMs, but I can tell you now, you're not going to get a fair shake for this bitch. I'm going to let you know right now, Keffels, all right? You're not getting a fair shake with this bitch right here. Oh, hell no. No. After everything you did and how you were literally, like, a terror... You were, people were scared to talk about you because you were deplatforming people left and right. Are you kidding me? You will never get a fair shake with me. And I mean every fucking word I say. You will never get a fair shake with me. Ever.
She's insane, dude. I think she's insane. She's going after me it's so unprovoked. And I told her, like, yeah, it's not me not wanting to give you a fair shake. It's just that I don't feel like I want to talk about this on stream, right? And then oh, my God. She's just so, like, wishy-washy. She knows my opinions. She wants me to be transphobic. It's insane. It's
yes,
so malicious.
Yeah. So she has something to say about you. That's exactly it.
I think what probably happened is she has a real gripe with, like, other people in the commentary community. And because you're, like,
Mike Lopez, shut up.
You get... Like, you catch strays or whatever. Like, I understand where she's coming from with some of this stuff. Like, the tweets that are made on the Alpha. Like, I can understand why those tweets made her uncomfortable. But, like, I want to put it on the record here. I don't think you're transphobic. I think that you've said some really yikesy shit on that account, but I don't think you're transphobic. I just think you're too edgy for your own good sometimes.
That account doesn't say anything that I truly believe. It was just, like, me making jokes.
I know that, but it's like the...
But why are you, like, equating it to me? The only thing that's related to me in that account is that I typed it, you know?
Yeah. I don't want to bring up old shit, but, like, yeah, it's...
Wait, what old shit?
Was
me being edgy?
Well, yeah, a little too edgy for your own good. Like, you've had problems in the past where people have dug up old stuff and they've, like...
Like, Black Lives Matter song and stuff like that?
That's what I was referring to, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, well...
Because, like, some of these tweets happened after the BLM song.
Yeah, some of it happened around that time, too.
Yeah, so you understand why it's like, okay, maybe... Maybe you haven't really learned from that situation.
What?
I mean, I'm asking the question.
I remember specifically Tipster telling me, and has always maintained, that words are words, and it depends on the context in which they say those words. And now he's saying this. Like, bro.
I'm just begging the question.
I'm not publicly broadcasting this shit to, like, millions of people. The random tweets from, like,
I mean,
years ago. And
you
know, everyone knows I have, like, a
BLM song to, like, a bunch of people.
Yeah,
either.
Yeah, exactly. So I'm not trying to be legitimately hateful. I just like being edgy for fun.
Yeah, I don't think you're a hateful person.
In spaces where no one will get offended or genuinely hurt by it.
Okay.
Yeah, like, I say the N-word in private. Like, but I say it in places where no one will get offended. And it's not that often. Like, oh. I'll admit that right now. Like,
based.
It just, like, I care about people's feelings, and I care about, like, based. The progressive social culture, which is why I, like, comment on it and give my opinion. You know, I made that tweet saying, like, LGBT indoctrination is not real, and I genuinely believe that and all that, right? But sometimes
I
just want to goof off on, like, an account, like, once ever, like, how many times did I tweet on that account, though? Like, 20 times in the past, like, decade? Like,
yeah, when I found out about it,
I was able to scroll
all the way to the beginning of it, because you don't tweet on it very much.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The account primarily existed for me to follow blocked accounts.
I didn't even know. I thought it was funny when I found out about it, and I was like, I had the account blocked, because you were, like, fucking with me on a dead account. I don't even remember blocking it, but obviously I did.
Yeah, it's funny. It's just whatever. I'm just trolling, you know? And it's like, and I'm glad, I mean, the account was, like, meanest to you, I guess. All I said is, like, what the fuck happened to this guy? So I'm glad you understand, and, like, so many people understand, but it's like, you know, my sense of humor has always been, like, absurdist, even with, like, the talk about the allegations and let me speak and all that. Like, obviously, mm-hmm. It's not rooted in any, like, social issue, but it's still, like, me, like, going ham and going nutto. Like, I just think it's funny to be, like, blunt and nutto, and I personally laugh at it. But if I'm gonna do it in an edgy way, I'll do, like, dude, it's not like I do this constantly. Like, people are trying to make me out to be, like, Creepshow art or something. Like, that's
no,
like, the
I don't
only
think
fucking...
Meowser for two. Says the guy defending a woman who had a phase. Thank you for the two, Meowser.
Somebody in my chat said that earlier, and I was like, no, he's not fucking Creepshow art. He had a fucking alt account that he was a little too edgy on. That's it.
Okay, can we please stop comparing everybody to Creepshow art? Jesus Christ. Okay?
Ooh.
Please. And long story, I'll fill you in later. It was crazy. It was a crazy-ass story, dude. Very crazy-ass story. Had to deal with alt accounts, 10 years of stalking someone and writing shit on Locale about their friends. Yes, it was a huge story. It's what got me monetized, actually.
This is not Creepshow art, like you're stalking people on the account or whatever the fuck.
So that's why I'm upset. I mean, and hopefully you do forgive me, because like I did not... I genuinely just didn't think you would mind, because it's not like you said anything secret. Like, I feel like everything you send those DMs are stuff you'd say publicly too, right? Like,
with
me in replies.
Yeah, I mean, what did I say? She's trolling you, bro, like, the whole time. Okay, that's fair. Don't think it's funny, but it's trolling nonetheless. Wouldn't signal boost anything calling you transphobe. Okay, I'm remembering this now. You were upset with me because I retweeted a tweet from Keffels, and you interpreted it to be about you, and the original tweet was not about you.
Yeah. And I didn't even bring up that context of that conversation, because that's, like, even more, like, private than what I, showed. It's just so, like, I was just thinking of, like, what you said. I wasn't, you know.
But, I don't know. There's nothing bad in it. I just don't like the idea of, like, just putting my shit out there, like, just completely, like, unprovoked. Because, again, it felt like I was being dragged into something that didn't have anything to do with me. But I'll get over it.
Well, I mean, you know, I think it's relevant. I didn't think it was random, but...
Toots, don't at me. I subtweet. Do not at me, okay? I subtweet. Subtweeting is a fucking art, all right?
And
it is an art form.
And just to confirm, Tipster did not get over it.
Get over what?
He just said he'll get over this whole thing.
No, he hasn't got over it. No, he hasn't.
I don't care what Rubzilla said. But yeah, dude, I am just genuinely upset. It's like so disheartening too, because like I wasn't trying to, like, hate on Keffels. Like, all, you know, Augie and Nick, they all hate on Keffels. They all, like, shit on Keffels and all this shit. I'm not as, like, in tune with her past, so maybe I'd be more harsh with her if I did. But I was always trying to be, like, nice and cordial in DMs. Like, I never wanted to be friends with Keffels, but I never, like, wanted to, like, be enemies or go after her either. Whenever people call her her dead name, like, I hate that shit. I fucking, consistently, you'll see, like, if it happens on my YouTube and I see it, I remove the comment. If it happens on my Twitter, I hide the reply. I've been, like, nice to her. And then she just takes this, like, little thing that has nothing to do with her, and it's on an account that's a complete joke. I was pro-trans even back then. And just twists it into me being transphobic. Like, what is this shit, man?
Yeah. I don't know. I mean, that's a her question, man. But again, you're not really willing to talk to her, so I don't really know if you'll ever get an answer for that.
I am willing to talk to her, but she blocked me.
Okay. Well, like I said, I can ask her to unblock you, but I mean,
if she wants to talk to me, she can, but I feel like I've said everything I want to say, right? But, like, mm-hmm. You can't say that, like, oh, I should have talked to her about,
like,
it when she blocked.
Why didn't they, like, hey, listen, why don't we get together at this time or stop the stream or get together at a different time and all three of them could have a talk? Why didn't they do that?
Tipster doesn't want to be involved, man. We'll never know.
He was.
You're all blocked.
He didn't want to be involved, but he was involved enough to put him on a live stream with Keffels.
And that is what we call a topsy-turvy.
Talk to me.
Well, I mean, when I said that, I didn't know that, though.
Yeah, but you just said it, like, just now, right? Like, I don't know.
Well, no, I didn't say that right just now. I said it earlier.
You did just say it just now,
would
bro, what?
Would you be willing to talk to her right now if she was down?
Sure, right now in the stream, yeah.
Wait!
Block you, but, I mean, sure, so.
Just twist it into me being transphobic. Like, what is this shit, man?
Yeah. I don't know. I mean, that's a her question, man. But again, you're not really willing to talk to her. So I don't really know if you'll ever get an answer for that.
I am willing to talk to her, but she blocked me.
Okay. Well, like I said, I can ask her to unblock you, but I mean,
if she wants to talk to me, she can, but I feel like I've said everything I want to say, right? But, like, mm-hmm. You can't say that, like, oh, I should have talked to her about it when she blocked me.
Well, I mean, when I said that, I didn't know that, though.
Yeah, but you just said it, like, just now, right? Like, I don't know.
Well, no, I didn't say that right just now. I said it earlier.
You just said that he didn't want to talk to him. You just said that he didn't want to talk to her. What? Oh, my God, dude.
Would you be willing to talk to her right now if she was down?
Sure, right now in the stream, yeah.
Let me message her.
Nip it in the bud.
Alright. I just sent her a message.
Bowblax is like, I'm ready!
Anyway.
But if she doesn't want to talk, I'm perfectly fine with that, too. Like, I just...
Alright, she's...
I need some animal crackers. This
Otherwise,
is
how's
me
everything
out.
Else going with you?
It's been pretty
Goddamn
good.
Animal
I mean,
crackers.
It's been pretty fine. I'm gonna work on a video today, but I got a little distracted by this.
What are you working on? If you don't
I
want to
do a Twitter versus on the Nick Merck stuff.
Oh, okay. What do you think about Nick Merck's? What's your take on it?
I think... I don't know his true opinions, but I think that his initial reply that got him banned from COD, like, it needed more context to say definitively if he's, like, being transphobic or homophobic.
Okay, I don't
yeah.
care about that.
You know, he could be saying, let's keep the kids out of, like, the riots, you know? Like, right. It doesn't necessarily...
Bowblax and you the opportunity to kind of talk, because obviously...
Oh, here we go.
As a side note, she said she's down to talk. She's going to take a quick smoke break real quick, but I'm going to add us to a group DM.
Alright.
This has been an interesting day, chat. Alright, what's up, Bowblax? She'll be here when she's here. I'll let her know I added it. Oh, I think she's already here.
Hold on just one sec.
Sure.
Hey, what's up, everyone?
Howdy. I thought I would offer Bowblax and you the opportunity to kind of talk, because obviously, like, there's some tension there, so I figured why not just, like, have you two get together and have a conversation. And by the way, Claire, this is we are live right now, just a heads up.
Oh, yeah, I know.
Okay. Just want
to
make sure.
No, I really appreciate it. I wanted to talk to Bowblax.
I bet you do know. And that's another thing about Miss Keffels. I love how Miss Keffels will go on a live stream with somebody, no matter who it is, no matter if it's Augie, no matter if it's Nick, now Bowblax, and we'll talk all nice and everything gets figured out and everything's good, and then she goes right back to Twitter and starts her shit again. She's done this, like, what, 3-4 times now? She does the same shit every time.
Almost like. it's a lie.
Almost like it's a lie. Oh my God, no, not coming from Keffels. Not
grift,
Queen Keffels.
A grift, as the kids say.
So I feel like a lot of our issues come down to a misunderstanding. And Twitter
I've
is
never
blood...
had any issue with you until literally today, when you called me transphobic.
You were mocking
when
me
you
for
know
drug
I'm
addiction,
not.
Like, just the other day.
I mocked you. I retweeted you. I mocked you. I sure as fuck did do it. And you know what? Do I feel kind of bad that I did that? Yeah. I do, because it was a low fucking blow. But you know what? After that joke y'all did, I didn't give a fuck. I gave that low fucking blow.
It was a month ago, and it was when you were calling me transphobic.
If I remember that interaction correctly, it was me taking a jab at your friends.
Yeah, you were calling me and my friends transphobic. And then you said it was a troll and a joke, and I'm like, okay.
Well, it started out as a misunderstanding of, like, a tweet being retweeted from Keffels that you thought, for some reason, was about you, and it wasn't about you. It was about a situation involving a trans creator.
I did not think it was about me. So I responded
well,
to
I
it being like,
that,
who...
I don't mean to cut you off, but when I retweeted that, you literally DM'd me asking me, why did you retweet a tweet calling me transphobic? And that's the tweet
because
I retweeted.
Because
Coco for two, I'm still pissed over her emergency GoFundMe. I'm sure you are. I'm sure you are. Ireland was pretty nice that time of the year, wasn't it?
I responded to Keffels asking who it was, and then she alluded that she was talking about me and my friends. And then that's when I thought she was talking about me and my friends, and that's when I DM'd you. Initially, I was just curious who she was talking about, just generally, because I saw it on my timeline.
So I can explain, just let me get back in for a second. I can explain the context, because, like, when you initially responded, I was kind of on guard, because the last time that you immediately asked, like, name names, you were talking to Tipster on the stream when Tipster announced that he was leaving the commentary community, and it seemed like you were trying to, like, you thought that I was talking about your friends because you wanted to, like, start some sort of drama. That's at least how I interpreted it immediately, so I was just defensive.
Okay, but I didn't think it was about... But then you, like, implied that it was about me and my friends, so of course I end up thinking that afterwards. Like, you let your fear become true by already assuming that that was the case.
I mean, yeah, I do think your friends are transphobic. I'll stand by that.
Okay, but do you think I'm transphobic?
I thought that tweet that you made was transphobic.
That account is, like, I've tweeted on it, I think, 20 times over the last 10 years, and it's, like, I think the account used to also be called Motherfucking Mark and other shit, and I just want to, like, I don't know, the account basically exists for me to follow, like, the blocked accounts for my Twitter versus thing. And, I don't know, I just wanted to make, like, random tweets, like, as, like, a really, like, horny character or whatever. It wasn't, like, legit, and I had, like, 2 followers. So, I don't know, especially after the conversations we've had in DMs where I've talked about supporting trans people. I literally tweeted out that LGBTQ indoctrination isn't real. I've made entire YouTube videos saying that, like, being transphobic is just as bad as being racist, et cetera, et cetera. And all this shit. And then you see one little tweet 4 years ago on an alt account I never use of me completely playing a character saying nothing that I actually believe, just me going nutso.
Okay, and I'll concede to that I didn't see that the tweet was 4 years old. Like, obviously people change and grow over time.
I wasn't even transphobic back then, though, but...
I also think it's just kind of, like, it's kind of a cop-out to, like, continuously respond in a character when everyone knows it's you and no one knows that you're playing a character.
How does nobody know I'm playing characters? Obvious, I've said it when it got leaked, and, like, the account's called Throbbing Horsecock, and it's saying, like, the most ridiculous shit, like, I...
How the hell did he come up with that name? I swear to God.
Because he's an alpha Chad, man, and he has that throbbing horsecock.
How in the hell did Bowblax come out with that name? Oh my God.
It's a man thing, Xylie.
It's a man thing?
Yeah.
Something really is wrong with y'all. Something is really wrong with y'all. Just
bro.
Saying.
Never mind. This is not my stream. I'm not gonna say it. I've been shackled.
Fuck Joe Biden. That's the tweet right under the trans tweet, by the way. Like, you really think
I
want to fuck
I don't
Joe
know
Biden?
The I don't know the lore on this. I didn't see the fuck Joe Biden. I didn't see that tweet.
It's right under the trans tweet though.
I was out all day.
Right,
I wasn't
though.
Like
fuck
browsing
Joe
the
Biden.
Account and like digging up dirt
she's
and
probably
doing
just
research
seeing people
on
tweet out the screenshots and stuff.
But then you called me transphobic and blocked me immediately. Don't you think that's like, especially after the conversations we had and all the stuff I've said that's pro-trans, don't you think that's like kind of jumping the gun? Like,
No. It led to y'all being on a stream together and her talking to you. That's what it led to. It led to more exposure. Just like her jumping in and talking to Augie led to, what, 1,200 people watching her, if not more? That was some exposure, right? How many people were in that chat when she was on there? Do you remember?
I thought it was already in the thousands before she got there.
No, it was. It was in thousands before that. But I can't remember. It was like 1,300, 1,400 maybe.
Somewhere in that ballpark.
Yeah. 1.6 at one point. Yeah. That's a lot of exposure to be able to jump on a stream like that and talk, huh?
You're right.
Wow. Almost like we fight with people on purpose so we can jump on streams, huh?
Well, if that's the case, then this is a grift.
Still not calling it a grift yet. Verse, what's up? You know what, Verse? You don't have the range to call me that, okay?
Like, extremely? If you just see one random tweet from an alt account that's 4 years old?
No,
versus all
friends,
of the evidence
I
of me.
I honestly didn't know how much I could trust you or how sincere you
Shut
were
up,
being.
Verse.
Like, Augie is he's very transphobic. Like, this isn't contestable. He's done and said and defends heinous shit.
What is done heinous shit? Like, what's
Augie,
he done?
Augie is very edgy. Like, he's one of those that it's the internet, it doesn't matter what I say type shit.
Did he beat up a transgender?
Because
when she says done and said.
Not that I know of. I don't know if Augie's ever been in a fight in his life, to be honest with you. But I have not heard about Augie doing something like that. But he's one of those that it's the internet, don't take it so serious. You know, words are just words. Like one of those free speech absolutist types. Maybe. I think he's a free speech absolutist. Yeah. Like what Burse is saying. Thinks that jokes are an attack. So, yeah.
I'm not really a free speech guy. I'm tired of hearing all this dumb shit.
Guilt by association is just so dumb, which is why I don't like Tipster for anything that you do, right?
Well, I would agree. Like, guilt by association is dumb. You were defending them saying that your friends aren't transphobic.
I don't think Augie or Nick are transphobic, but I can understand maybe why you would come to that conclusion. That's like a conversation that, you know, I don't want to speak for them, you know. But I genuinely don't think they're transphobic.
Well, see, the thing is, you're not supposed to be having a conversation about the rest of them. You're talking to Bowblax and why you think Bowblax is transphobic. Stop bringing the friends into it. Oh my gosh, he's moving the goalposts and it's fucking pissing me off.
I can't like defend everything they've ever said either.
Hey, Keffels, guess what? Guess what, Keffels? The dude right there in the camera that's right beside you in the call, he used to laugh about it, and just a few months ago, he was defending people making those jokes. Bro, what?
I just don't know. I'm not, like, familiar with it. I'm not them. But I just know what they've said in private and stuff like that, and in, you know, what I see and stuff, and I don't think they're transphobic. Like, literally, Nick goes out of his way to make sure that he, like, says the right pronouns for everybody, even if he dislikes them. He hates Jalen, but he always calls her she, you know? And I think he's always called you she, and I think he's mocked people for calling you he or by your dead name.
That's true, actually. So. Because when all that shit was going down with Keffels, Nick used to get frustrated because while he was checking Keffels on what she was doing, people would go under his tweets and say some transphobic shit, and he would knock them out, like either block them, hide the comment, because that's not what he was doing. He was checking her for what she was doing, and unfortunately, dumbasses would go under there and be transphobic. So.
Oh.
I will give him credit for that, because I do remember a conversation that, or rather a tweet that Nick put out back when people were initially critical of Keffels, He put out a tweet something along the lines of, I hate whenever we criticize Keffels, all these legitimately transphobic fucking people come out. Yep. And I had the same sentiment, because it's true. Like, back when we were critical of her, any time we would say anything negative of Keffels, and it was...
Wait, Inklet says there's a reason I haven't been around to mod for him recently. Okay, we gotta tell Matt Pitt to X you off.
Good. Are you talking about that picture of that tier list?
Is literally X'ing off the goth mobbies one by one as they drop.
All right, so side note.
Where's Beavers? Is anybody from Now Recording on here? Where the fuck is Matt Pitt? I'm surprised Matt's not in here. What the fuck?
Side note. Saggy. I like Saggy.
Friend I like of mine. Saggy Melons. Saggy Melons has always been really cool with me.
She sees that and she's like, oh, wow, I don't really see how you're all just being like this. I'm not going to offend or stop associating with Tipster. It's like, nobody asked you.
Yeah. Nobody's telling you have to stop associating. I don't care if Maggot, oh my God. I don't care if Saggy is friends with him or not. That has nothing to do with me. That has to do with her. I stopped being his friend when he took what I said in the DMs and made a fucking joke about it. And went about his way and even threw in his mental health as part of the fucking joke. Fuck you, dude. I remember when I was in the fucking DMs with you when you were fucking suicidal. I remember being there for you when no one else were. I remember being the last fucking person standing, and you did that to me. And that's what I get? You take my actual concerns for you and turn it into a fucking joke? Fuck all that shit. You can fuck right off with that bullshit. Fuck all that shit.
So is it safe to say we're not going to really get a Tipster stream for a while?
What do you mean?
I mean, all this heat, he ain't really going to make a stream.
What do you mean? I'm not going to be able to make a stream on him?
No, him.
Well, who's he? I'm pretty sure he's going to stream. He streamed tonight, didn't he?
Did he?
I don't know. I unfollowed him.
I was asleep.
Oh. I unsubscribed from him, so I don't know. I don't know. He'll go live. He'll act like this ain't happening. He gonna go about his business, act like this happened. He don't give a fuck who he hurt. He don't give a fuck. That legitimately hurt my fucking feelings. And then on top of it, put his mental health in there. Like, bro. I remember fighting with people... When he had taken that break, that one break, and I was in the DMs with him, and he's even told this on my channel. He told this on my channel, that I was in DMs with him and talking to him and trying to lift him up when he was down. And I was literally arguing with people behind the scenes over him, saying, listen, dude, you know, chill out on him. He's going through some shit right now, you know, and... You gonna take my concerns and make it into a fucking joke? Whatever.
Wasn't about her being trans or anything. All these like legitimately hateful fucking people would use that to bolster their transphobia, and it was like really fucking annoying.
I know. Pumpkin came right up to me on the desk and meowed at me. I know y'all heard it.
This is part of the problem though with being really neutral about different communities, right? Like, if you're just like, you know, I don't necessarily agree with what this creator's saying. And you don't take a stand against it, even if that creator is being explicitly transphobic and encouraging it, you're going to let that audience into your audience, and they're going to do that.
They've actually been leaving, because I've been making videos that are pro-trans, like the Sunny V2. Oh, yeah. I made a video on Sunny V2, okay. Lost a lot of subs off that. I made a video against synthetic man's transphobic
okay,
and
let
homophobic.
Me clarify it. Let me clarify. I wasn't talking about...
All right, Matt Pitt, let me see this. Hold on. We have a tweet from Matt Pitt. Okay, so Matt Pitt has updated the goth mommy list. You see this, Leon?
No, I don't. I have another tab open.
Wait. You don't see it in the live stream?
No, I had another tab open.
Oh, okay.
I'm looking at it now.
Yeah, Matt has updated the goth mommy tier list.
What am I missing?
He X'd out. Let's see. Hold on. Where's Inklet? Inklet's in here somewhere. Which one's Inklet? There's more X's on the board now. Let's put it that way.
I say, I hope you're not asking me because I don't know.
No, I'm telling you. I was telling you.
No, you were saying, like, where's Inklet? And I was like, I don't.
Good job. Good job, Matthew. You're on the job. Good job. I'm proud of you. All right, let's keep going.
About you, your audience, but I was specifically talking about, like, Augie's audience, Nick's audience, not Nick's audience. One of, like, the worst ones has got to be Tom's audience, right? Because, like, you look at his channel and, like, some of his biggest videos, he's just, like, constantly referencing Kiwi Farms. He won't say a single bad thing about Kiwi Farms.
All boils down to Kiwi Farms, right? And it wasn't even Miss I Lied About Kiwi Farms doxing me when it wasn't Kiwi Farms that did it. It's always about Kiwi Farms, ain't it?
So, like, you go into the comment sections on, like, any of his video about me, and it's just literally full of people complaining that he won't dead name me because he's appealing to that audience.
So, like, Tipster earlier in this conversation before you came in said it's annoying whenever you do something that everyone is like, oh, what's your thoughts on that, Tipster? Would you agree with that? Like, people shouldn't be like...
Here's my question. What does Bowblax have to do with Tom's audience?
I think they say it in this, like, something about cross-contamination or something.
You know what?
People watch him, people watch Bowblax, people watch Tipster. I think that's what they mean.
Look, here's my thing. I don't give a fuck what community you come from. I don't give a fuck what, I have my own rules for my chat, right? Nick has his own rules for his chat. Augie has his own rules for his chat. All right? I'm not going to tell Augie or Tom or any... Actually, I'm not going to tell anybody how to run their chat. I run mine the way I run it. You run yours the way you run it. It's your chat. It is none of my fucking business how you run it and who is in it and what they say in it. It's none of my fucking business. I know how I want mine ran. And that's my business. It's nobody's fucking business how I run mine. It's none of my fucking business what my mods do. Just like it's none of my fucking business what goes on in their chat. I hate that fucking shit, yo.
I'm going to derail this again because noticed it. This is why I don't like Discord. Look at the left and look at all them fucking tabs.
Yeah, mine's easier. I have folders. And I have all of my, every single Discord I'm in, I have muted, so I don't see all those numbers.
I look at that. It's like, if any of y'all got your Discord, like, where you got all these servers you in, you a dork. I'm sorry.
Okay,
like,
fuck you. I'm in a lot of servers, thank you. But I'm in those servers for reasons.
I'm glad.
I'm a social butterfly.
I'm glad that fake cop is in here because his Discord on thin ice.
Oh.
It's about time I start cutting some Discords again.
Unico, thank you for joining the Just Saying Squad. I appreciate it. Thank you very much. All right, let's keep going.
Getting on Tipster's ass.
Wait, Rag, Xylie is a social wasp? Rag, you're on thin ice right now. I'm just saying. Yeah,
it's the one leg man.
He's tab shaming. What one leg man?
What one leg man? The only one leg man.
Hi, Matt Pitt. How are you?
Hi, Xylie. I'd hate to interrupt, but I just wanted to give my, I guess, bi-weekly statement on the Goth Mommies.
Okay,
because,
yeah.
Because Nintendo Mills in the chat being like, get Ashley off the list. She's not a real Goth Mommy. The list is not real. These people aren't literal Goth Mommies.
Yeah,
I get
Nintendo
that some people.
Chill the fuck
I get
out.
That some people, like, interacted with Tipster more than others, but nonetheless, if your name was around Tipster, if you orbited Tipster, I considered you a Goth Mommy. It's a joke. It's not real. It can't get you. It can't hurt you. It won't kidnap you. It won't destroy your career. You're going to be okay. Bitch.
Okay, Matt. Good job. Thank you, Matt. Yeah. Thank you.
Breaking news. Chris just called me the N-word in DMs.
Oh. Matt, would you like to stay and go through this Bowblax video? We're halfway done.
the Bowblax one? Sure.
Okay. It's up to you. You don't have to. I'm just, you know, offering it since you were here.
I've seen this freaking video like 3 times.
Oh, have you?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't know that.
No, it's cool. It's cool. It's cool. I'll pop in afterwards, though.
Okay, no problem.
Yep, yep.
Did he just say pip, pip?
No, he said yip, yip. What? Leon, shut up. Let's keep going.
No, I mean, for sure.
So yeah, then why are you getting on my ass for audiences of my friends?
Thank you. Thank you.
I don't think she's getting on your ass right now. Because
Tipster. Oh, no, Tipster. Let Keffels talk, okay? She is a grown-ass woman of 2023. Let her talk. You don't have to white knight for her. She is a grown-ass woman. Let her talk.
Audience and Nick's audience and Augie's audience.
I don't think she's getting on your ass. She's explaining her reasoning as to why she feels the way.
Yeah, but I don't understand how my friend's audience is having transphobic.
Unico, thank you for gifting 5 memberships. I appreciate it. 07's in the chat for Unico, please. 07's and or kitty salute for Unico, please. Thank you. I appreciate it.
Transphobic viewers outweighs all of the other pro-trans shit I've said.
She's not talking about
Huda. Like, why do I... But no, she is talking about the reason she called me transphobic off the horse tweet. And then she's like, she literally said, I can't trust you, and this is the reason why. Like, I can't trust you when you say you're pro-trans or whatever.
You can see, though, you can see, right, that how it would make someone suspicious if you're saying, like, I can't tell if the people that I associate pretty closely are or aren't transphobic. I can't defend their actions one way or another. However, my actions don't reflect
that. Well, it's because you're not saying any specific actions of them, and I don't have an encyclopedia in my head of everything Augie and Nick have said, but genuinely, I don't think they're transphobic, and nothing I've personally seen them say, publicly or privately, indicates they're transphobic. So you'd have to give me an example.
I mean, I will say, like, Augie's definitely said...
Good night, Leah.
That's some pretty sussy shit on his Rumble streams. So, I will say that much. Seen that. Yeah, I don't know if you watch his Rumble streams or if you, like, partake in those.
I only watch his streams that I'm on, so no. Probably not.
Yeah, he said some pretty sussy shit on his Rumble streams. Like, they were their intention was, like, to mock me because I was talking about, like, the nominal Naomi, like, trans breastfeeding thing. But they were making a lot of, like, comments that could be interpreted as transphobic during that stream.
But yeah, Keffels, you do see how you're,
so
like, reasoning.
So, my question is, instead of just saying, they're saying sussy shit, why don't I just pull up a clip like anybody would?
Yeah.
Like, that's how you nip that in the bud.
My question is, if he left the commentary community, why is he watching Augie on Rumble? Because Augie hasn't been streaming that long on Rumble. Why was he watching Augie on Rumble? Mm. Or did he get a clip from somebody of Augie on Rumble?
I mean, if you got a clip of Augie saying something, is it that hard on any of these streaming softwares to pull it up?
Mm-hmm. I agree.
For calling me transphobic, it's like, from my point of view and from probably everyone else's point of view, it's just like, so...
She even conceded, like, on that. She said she didn't even realize the tweet was like 4 years old or whatever.
Yeah, I mean, I didn't understand any of the context from
If you were legitimately concerned, as Tipster said before you joined this conversation, why didn't you just DM me about it instead of blocking me and then calling me a transphobe? It seems like really extreme to do that.
Because I don't know how you're going to react. Like, in the course of all of this, you ended up leaking all of Tipster's DMs. Like,
not all of them.
That seems like a pretty extreme reaction as well.
Yeah, when you call me a sexual harasser and a transphobe, of course I'm going to get upset. Like, you say you don't know what my reaction would be if you DM'd me, so you assume that my reaction would be better if you blocked me, called me a transphobe, and then followed up by saying I'm a sexual harasser?
Like, yeah, I'm going to stand by it that was really creepy, like, consistently doing that kind of thing. Understanding that it's a character now, I feel a bit better, but I don't know how I was supposed to understand. I thought you were just like, you just had a weird alt.
No.
Because I don't know the history. I don't know any of the history of any of it. I just saw like the tweets because
then
people were talking
about it. Maybe
you
shouldn't have tweeted about it if you didn't know anything about it.
Maybe Tipster should have explained it to you. I don't know.
See, I feel like
I was just trolling back, you know, like how you've trolled in the past, you know, and I thought, you know, because you went aggro on me and I'm like, OK, how do I respond to this? I could get angry. You blocked me. I can't talk to you about it. why not just play into the character a little more and like kind of let you know it's a joke, like hint hint wink wink, like I don't actually have a 9-inch cock and want to fuck you, you know?
Well, he doesn't.
No, he doesn't, apparently. Apparently Echo has breaking goth mommy news. Another goth mommy is attacking the list. What? Another goth mommy is attacking the list? What are you talking about, Echo? Oh my god.
Okay, well,
so
I didn't know.
That was my approach, but...
Do you think... Can I ask you a question, Bowblax? So, like, obviously yeah. You're upset with, like, she said that, like, you know, you were sexually harassing her or whatever, and I can understand why those tweets would make her feel uncomfortable 100%. Do you think it's kind of, like, fucked up to kind of, like, turn it around and say, well, like, she was harassing me. She sent me, like, a video of her jiggling her tits when it's, like, it's a meme about her, like, imitating...
Yeah, but mine's a meme, too.
But like you, but you can understand how, like, okay, she's, like, saying I'm sexually harassing her, and then you flip it around and do the same thing. You can understand how that's kind of fucked up, right?
No, that's not fucked up at all, Tipster. No, that's not fucked up at all. What if that made Josh uncomfortable? A woman is literally in his DMs jiggling her tits. What, do you think that women can't sexually harass men? Isn't that a little bit off kilter in what you believe now? Oh... That's right. I'm gonna keep my mouth shut because I almost said something that's pretty fucking bad. I'm just saying that could have been sexual harassment. I'm not gonna continue what I was about to say.
Yeah, it is kind of weird, like responding.
She
to
made
an
sexual messages to me and say
this isn't
not
sexual.
Sexual.
It's a meme. It's a meme message of her impersonating Rouge the Bat.
No.
Daniel, I know Chris is in the chat. He's a mod. Daniel, I don't know why you try to tell me things that I know. What's up, Chris? What? Echo was right. Oh, wait. Ashley has me blocked, so you're going to have to send me a screenshot because Ashley has me blocked.
This dude just said it's not sexual. It's just Rouge the Bat physics. She's bouncing her titties.
She's bouncing her titties. She's bouncing
like,
her titties. The fuck?
Mind you, he's trying to mediate a conversation.
Mm-hmm.
Now look, I know the education system has failed us, by the way.
Thank you, Fairy, for letting me know Leon was here. Yeah?
Yeah, that's crazy. I just showed up. I know the education has failed most Americans. I don't know the definition of mediate, but I'm willing to bet my left hand what he's doing ain't mediating.
No. No, he's talking for her at times. He's talking for her at times. That's what he's doing.
I'm not even into dudes. Like, I was literally like making a joke about jiggle physics in Sonic Adventure 2. I was trying to like connect with you in some way because I always thought that you were cool, but I didn't know how to connect with.
Okay, once again, she can make edgy jokes. He cannot. No one else can, guys. Just to let y'all know, no one's allowed to make edgy jokes but Keffels, Queen Keffels. And Tipster can only make edgy jokes that Queen Keffels says okay to. Just to let you know. That's the rule of the land now.
With you and I think,
I'll
okay, wait, I was
I
talking
make
about Sonic
jokes,
on stream
I
once.
Make
and then
jokes,
someone
I make all jokes.
I'm going to try and bridge the gap here because I know you like Sonic.
Well, I was trying to meme with you on that account too. Like, I'm not.
But I
like...
didn't know about the horse thing. Like, and then responding to like the accusation, which is, are we fucking or not? That's just, dude.
Also, the accusation was I'm transphobic, and then I said, on the alt account in character, women can't keep the answer straight. I refer to you as a woman. Wouldn't that answer that I'm not transphobic?
I think the issue is that you're assuming that people know what you know. Well, not everyone knows exactly. Everything.
Yeah, I mean, like
you know
a lot of people didn't even know that the alt account existed.
What? That makes no goddamn sense. What did she just say?
I think.
To answer straight, I refer to you as a woman. Wouldn't that answer that I'm not transphobic?
I think the issue is that you're assuming that people know what you know. Well, not everyone knows exactly everything.
Yeah, I mean,
that
like
you
a lot of people didn't even know this alt account existed until you accidentally leaked it on stream. So, like, there's a lot
of
lore that's there that like people weren't.
But why would she accuse me of being transphobic without looking into it? And she assumes I know a bunch of things as well. Like, I knew that, like, oh, you were joking about jiggle physics and not, like, trying to
do
something
legit. I mean, to be fair, that tweet is very, very, like the DMs that you leaked about that, it's very clear what the intention is there.
And I think my tweets are very clear.
So look, it wasn't clear to me.
Yeah.
Like, you send in a GIF for your titties bouncing, it's like, hey, you trying to bond over Sonic? You know how many GIFs of Sonic they got?
True.
And you using your titties bouncing as the point?
True.
As well.
I feel like if you were to show any person that account without giving them the context that you just gave us on the stream, they would not know what they were looking at.
Then why, when I tweet out the jiggle physics thing, without giving the context of you saying it's not a joke, everybody thinks it's sexual harassment as well? It literally goes both ways.
Because you're your audience is cross-pollinated with Nick and Tommy.
Yeah, you gotta understand Tom's there's like a lot of people who follow you that they already don't like her.
Okay, fuck off. Fuck off with that goddamn... Fuck off. Just fuck off. Okay, you know what? Okay, hold on. I'm eating onion rings. Leave me alone. All right, look.
Huh? What happened to the animal crackers?
I had like six, and then I had a bag of onion rings here. And as Keppels was talking, I was like, I really want some onion rings, and they were right there. Anyway, okay. When I left the beauty drama community, all right, and when they found out I was going over here, all right, and starting to intermingle and stuff like that, do you know I automatically became racist? I automatically became homophobic? I automatically became transphobic.
Welcome to the club, baby.
I went where the racist white men were. That was what was literally said about me. Fuck.
I don't even know them, and I'm all these things.
That shit. Fuck that guilt by association shit. Fuck off.
And wait, if the name of the game for Keffels is guilt by association, Tips is transphobic. Because you know who he used to hang around that gets called transphobic? Me.
True.
So it ain't looking good for your big dog.
True.
Just to be clear, I don't hate trans people. I hate trans activists.
What you say against her that's negative, they're just going to be like, yeah, Bowblax, call her out,
man. And Keffels' audience,
you know,
is cross-pollinated with trans allies and stuff, and I don't think that's wrong.
Guess who else had a cross-pollinated audience? You do, Tipster. I mean, granted, you've lost a lot of them now, but so do you, Tipster. So do you, Tipster. The same people who watch Augie, Nick, Tom, Bowblax, Willie, even me, they watch you too. So what does that say about your audience? I understand you got a bunch of new people that came from Keffels on there. But what does that say about you, Tipster? Because they still watch you. What does that say about you? Does that make you transphobic, Tipster? Huh? Because that's how
crazy.
That works, right? That's how that works, right? Guilt by association, cross-pollination, right? That's how that works. You think you got rid of all of them? No, dog, you didn't.
The fuck?
Wrong, but saying I'm a transphobe in front of like an audience of primarily trans pro people, it's really damaging.
Yeah, he did echo. He absolutely did echo. Tipster used to make a lot of those jokes too. Yes, he did.
Fancy ranking towards me can be applied to Keffels equally, if not more.
Right,
so.
And I'm not trying to like attack you. I'm just trying to like explain to you. You can understand why these things can be interpreted this way. That's all I'm saying. I'm not trying to like make personal attacks at you or like fuck you, Bowblax, or anything. I'm just trying to explain it to you. Like, this is why these things can be interpreted in these ways.
Yeah, like,
but
literally,
you went after me before I even made those responses to you on the alt account because of a tweet that I made 4 years ago. You went at me unprovoked when I've never, ever, ever, ever even like said anything mean to you before, besides like the Coke thing when I thought you were calling me transphobic, which we discussed in DMs.
Yeah, no,
really out of the blue and kind of fucked up, in my opinion, for you to instigate this.
I don't think it's fucked up. And to be fair,
call me transphobic?
Like, the situation was instigated by you in the first place.
No, it wasn't. Me, 4 years ago?
Not 4 years ago.
It was instigated 4 years ago, Keffels. What? Keffels, what? He made the tweet 4 fucking years ago. Good night, Inklet.
Even knew you?
Because this started back when I made the tweet about Euphoria Tori, and you were asking me to name
it. We resolved it in DMs.
Right. Cool. So like when I see that that screenshot, and I wasn't looking for the year on it. I just saw that it got.
Okay, bitch. Just say that you didn't. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. And you want to be commentary? You want to make videos commentating on people and you can't even read the facts of the subject that you're looking at? You can't read a fucking year on a tweet? You can't read every word of a tweet, but yet you want to do commentary? Get the fuck out of here. I swear to God, bro.
Leaked. I wasn't like doing some big investigative hit piece to try and take you down. I don't think this is going to really affect you in any way.
It doesn't take investigative to read the goddamn date on a tweet. It doesn't take investigation. It's called reading the fucking tweet. Just saying. Rike, I am Southern. What are you talking about? I am Southern. Right, but in there, did Xylie just become Southern for a second?
I am also Southern.
Yes. We're both Southern.
But she's like old Southern because she got that thick accent.
I'm not old. Fuck you.
What you are? Accent is Xylie. Your accent is thicker than mine, and you know it.
I can't.
I know you can't help it.
I can't help it.
It's how you talk. I'm not shitting on you for how you talk. I'm stating a fact. You have a thicker Southern accent.
Oh God, I hate it here.
I was really just hurt. Like I thought you just lied to me. Because you're saying like, oh, I'm not transphobic. My friends aren't transphobic. And then I see this on your alt account. And like, I immediately assumed you just made the alt account look really fucking weird. So no one would assume it's you.
No.
Yeah, he named it Throbbing Horsecock. I mean, I would have never in a million years would have figured out who was Throbbing Horsecock.
It was me being bored because I had that account to track block Twitters. And I was just bored and wanted to like, be silly, basically. Like, all of the statements on there are so, like, ludicrous. Like, to think any of those statements are legitimate is just, like, it's kind of nutty.
Yeah, and it, like, there's been other incidences in between this that really did sour my perception of the whole thing. Like, you trying to, like, compare getting a tattoo to gender-affirming healthcare. And it's...
Yeah, they're both major alterations to the body. Obviously, there's differences.
One of them is cosmetic.
Like,
another one is treatment for
gender. Yeah, but the thing is, that's such a complex situation.
Yeah, and I feel like a lot of the people... And it's funny enough, I actually thought about, like, at some point, maybe inviting you on stream so we can have, like, a serious conversation about it, Bowblax, because I feel like a lot of the people who take the stance that you do, they
the
don't
last
actually
thing
know
we need
how the process
is
works.
Tipster
like,
hosting
kids
a debate
just go
panel.
Into a doctor's office and say, hey, I'm a girl now, give me HRT. And it doesn't work that way.
Yeah, I don't think it works that way either. It's a nuanced discussion. But I say, like, I've also said that, like, I think LGBT indoctrination is not real. And people have responded under that tweet and have clarified what I meant, which is that, like, I think that before making such a major life permanent decision, they should be over 18 because then they have, like, you know, they can, like, think it through and be 100% sure, you know? Just, like, it's a big step. Like, marriage is a big step or, you know, what have you. So I just think... Yeah, maybe, like, it's a little too early to do it as a kid.
Like, one of the problems, though, with that, like, for instance, I started my transition when I was 16. If I were to wait, I would have had to end up doing a lot more surgeries than I eventually had to do because I would have completed male puberty. So if I already knew I was trans, everything worked out, I'm, like, 13 years into my transition, and I have no regrets. If I were to have to wait, it would have ended up making my transition a lot more difficult.
Yeah, that's the purpose of things like puberty blockers and stuff like that.
Like,
that's why they do that.
Like, in an honest conversation, because it is a difficult conversation, like, I definitely think that there should be, like, a cap on the earliest that you can start hormones. Because, for instance, I've heard that, like, people who start before puberty starts in the beginning have problems having orgasms as adults, which I think is really weird. And sometimes they don't have enough like penile tissue to end up doing sexual reassignment surgery. There are alternatives to it, obviously, but it's like such a deep conversation.
Xylie, do you know why they don't have enough penile tissue?
No, I don't know enough about this part of the subject that I'm not saying anything. I'm going to be honest. I'm about fast forward it because I am not learned with this conversation.
They don't have enough throbbing cock.
Jen, when the audience is like so intermingled that.
Oh, here we go.
Because, like, obviously, like, you have friends that have a lot more transphobic opinions than you who would disagree with the...
That has nothing to do with him! You're talking to Bowblax. Have that conversation with other people!
...positions that you have. And
yeah,
because it's all, like, the same community, the audience is, like, so intermingled that... Whenever a trans person would end up getting into some sort of argument with anyone in the comments.
Okay, you dumb bitch. You do realize the commentary community has trans people in it, right? You do fucking realize that, right? You do realize that Augie's community alone has trans people in it. You do realize that trans people watch the commentary community, are in the commentary community, are in the discords, are in the chats, are on Twitter talking to them. You do understand that, right? You do realize you are not the only trans person talking to these people. Jesus fucking Christ. Bro!
I don't know if Chris is still in here. But I don't know if it was him or whoever it was that was in that call when we watched this. Somebody called Keffels a trans icon, and I had to shut that down because, no, she's not. She's an internet personality who struggles to understand she's not the only trans person to exist. Like, there's more than one trans person, male or female, that walks this earth, and a lot of them don't really care about anything Keffels be saying.
Chris said I didn't call her that. She thinks she is.
No, somebody in there. She's a trans icon.
I don't understand. I mean, does she not realize that trans people are all over in the commentary community? They're all in the commentary community. They're all in there. And they're not just watching. They talk in the chats. They're in the Discord. They mod for people. They mod in the Discord. Hell, a couple of them have channels. I mean, what the fuck? She acts like they're not here. Of course they're here. And they're part of the fucking community. The fuck is wrong with her?
That's it. Kristen Arg is a trans icon.
Jesus, Lord have mercy. She acts like we have no trans people in this community. That's so dumb. Holy shit. And guess what? Those same people, they watch Augie. They watch Tom. They watch Nick. They watch Bowblax. The fuck, dude?
Commentary community.
God,
in a negative
way. So much.
There would be like gripers and shit in their replies. And it's not necessarily anything that you did. It's just like the laissez-faire attitude of a lot of people in the commentary community that makes it so this happens.
And then those people will get equally as mad when I say something like pro-trans. Like, I can't, like, I'm not trying to cater to any specific audience. I'm just saying what I think on Twitter. And obviously when I say something in a YouTube video, it's way, way, way more like researched and definitive. Like Twitter, I just kind of just throw out like kind of opinions I have for the sake of starting discussion or whatever, but on YouTube I'm very much like firm in everything I say. And my YouTube audience, I mean, it's literally like multiple times bigger than Augie and Nick's, and it's like, you know, it's not all the same audience, but
no,
regardless of all that, it's just like
I've really appreciated it because like of all of the people I've mentioned so far, you've been like the most open, like the most receptive person to actually talking to me. You've made videos where you actually say something positive about me, where if I do anything anyone likes in that community, they're never going to actually mention that because they hate me so much.
Yeah, and you say you appreciate that, which I believe, but then you go and jump to the conclusion that I'm transphobic instead of DMing me.
I think it's just like I have so much distrust.
I think she's... Oh, God. I almost said it. Okay. I think she's full on dumb enough, because I almost said the other word. I think she's full on dumb enough to not realize that the commentary community is actually mixed with a lot of different people. You have people who are on the left. You have people who are on the right. You have people that are everything under the sun. You know, you have, it literally is a conglomerate of a bunch of different people in the commentary community. There is no one set type of person in the commentary community. It literally is a conglomerate of different sexes, different races, different, because when I was told about the commentary community, you think they were all white and holding Nazi signs. Seriously. Swear to God. Based. The way I was told about the commentary community. There's everybody here. Everybody. Including gay people. Including trans people. Everyone is in the commentary community. I hate to break it to you. Obviously, I'm talking to Keffels, Leon. Obviously. Keffels, I hate to break it to you, but it's just not the people that you're talking about right now. It's everybody here. I mean, look at me. I don't even like to say the R word. And I'm part of it. I don't even like to say the R word. Everybody jokes me that I don't say the R word. I've said it a couple times.
I would say it, but I've been shackled.
I mean, you could say it. I don't care if you say it. I just don't say the R word.
Well, Keffels is retarded.
Yeah, see, you could say
Tipster
it.
Tipster is retarded too.
There you go.
And anyone co-signing, gaslighting somebody into feeling bad for a bot Twitter account, you're retarded too.
I will say you did that with a flourish. I was kind of impressed, not going to lie.
It's because it's the voice. That New Orleans accent hits deep, baby.
I know that's right.
Around that community because of the way that I'm treated and because of
I'm going to get you a soundboard of all my best slurs. That way you could get away with it.
Oh, I can get away with it because it'll technically be you saying it? Is that what you're doing? I hate you. Shut up.
I'll buy you a stream deck and just add the sounds to it.
No. I can see you coming in chat now. Hit it, Xylie. Hit it. Hit the N-word. Hit the N-word, Xylie. Hit it. It's me saying it. Hit it, Xylie. I can see you now doing that.
Absolutely.
With the far right, that it was easy for me to jump the gun. I am sorry. I didn't know that you were using that account like that.
And hopefully you do understand that, like, that account was just a joke and I was just playing into it because I felt like after you blocked me, like, that was kind of the only way I could do it. That wasn't, like, harsh or whatever. I don't know. I was just I'm also trying to help people realize that, like, who, when the account leaked, a lot of people are like, oh, this is real opinions, but through those replies I'm like helping people realize, hey, it's just a joke. And I'm probably also just not going to tweet on that account ever again,
Josh. You're just like me. You're literally just like me. You don't even understand. You remember, like, the fucking Catboy Ranch account? You remember, like, all the drama?
I know there was, like, a drama around Catboy Ranch and shit.
Whenever they pull up old tweets from that account, people don't understand that entire account was a bit where I was playing a character, and they assume it's like 100% what I earnestly believe, which sounds fucking unhinged.
Yeah.
So if it sounds unhinged for you, wouldn't that mean, you know?
Bro.
Sounds a little bit unhinged for my good man, Bowblax.
Oh my God. I cannot stand her at all. I can't stand her. I truly cannot. Do we have to watch any more of this?
Hot take, autistic people are more marginalized than trans people, especially after this nonsense.
I feel like my brain is full of worms right now. Do we have to listen to the rest of this?
I mean, it's just going to be a continued effort of, hey, Bowblax, you did this, but Tipster, you do this, and Keffels, you do this, but it's different because no one understands your feelings. I think there's also the mention of, like, why he left being in DMs with all of you, and it was about the fucking Lolly thing, and how he didn't like how people in his chat or people from these other chats would be like, oh, Tipster's a pedo. But at no point in this stream did he think okay, now people from this chat are going to start calling Bowblax transphobic. That's the only other part that I think would be of interest to you.
Yeah, but unfortunately, and like, I don't have a time stamp. So
I have a pretty negative opinion of me, and I know that your friends do as well.
Yeah, I got a negative opinion of you.
I think there's this assumption about me, and I understand where it comes from.
I don't really have a negative opinion of Kevin.
I do, very much so.
It's mainly just because I don't care enough to try to find out the lore.
I absolutely have a negative opinion of her, and I will never give her a second chance. Ever. Ever. I don't care. I do not care.
They see me as this, like, nasty platformer that I want to ruin everyone's career and that I want to, like, make...
Because, honey, you tried to do that. What?
Everyone who crosses me in some insignificant way suffer, and that's really not true. Like,
I mean, if you take what happened today and just look at it at face value, it kind of does look true.
Thank you.
I mean, how is this different from other internet beef in the commentary community?
Like, you would know. You're not in the commentary community, bitch. And I'm going to tell you what. As long as I'm around, you won't be.
You just going to hold the door closed as she tries to come in?
She tries to walk in the door, I'm going to slam it right in her fucking face. Nah, bitch. Go do your own little thing over in your own community. Nah, bitch.
I'm glad I don't have a community.
Shit. I'll be damned.
I just got developed sperm that watch me.
Yep. Okay.
What?
True.
That's what they're called. People That's don't what we all are. We're developed sperm.
True. Very true. You're right.
It's based on tweets that are like 2 years old or 4 years old on alt accounts. And most people...
Yeah. I think...
I mean, he was really... As far as I remember, he basically said, well, you know, stay away from minors. But I don't actually remember how that ended. I just know that
What I remember from the conversation was something along the lines of, like, he said that he wasn't insinuating you were a pedophile, and then you just disagreed that you didn't believe him. That's kind of like how it with them calling her a pedophile. And they started trying to dig up clips of, like, can we find a clip of Tipster defending Keemstar's relationship with Brantley? And it's like, well, what does that have to do with anything? Yeah, I did defend his relationship with Brantley because there were, like, retards on the internet.
Oh, keep
people
going.
People assume that Tipster endorses everything you say. You think that is, a fair assessment for them to make as well?
What's an example of something that happened recently like that?
I could tell you one. There was you made a joke in response to Keemstar where you called him a pedophile, and everybody got super mad about that. Like, well, why is Tipster okay with them calling her a pedophile? And they started trying to dig up clips of, like, can we find a clip of Tipster defending Keemstar's relationship with Brantley? And it's like, well, what does that have to do with anything? Yeah, I did defend his relationship with Brantley because there were, like, retards on the internet saying he was a pedophile for dating a 19-year-old girl, which is legal fucking age, right? So what does that have to do, me defending his relationship because it's not pedophilia? What does that have to do with Keffel's calling Keemstar a pedophile as a joke?
Yeah, I mean, it's not pedophilia. I still think
so it's okay that she calls Keemstar a pedophile. Bro,
It's not okay to have a Twitter account where you're making jokes about a trans person. But she can, after explaining that, you know, I know he's not a pedophile, still go online and make the crack that he's a pedophile. But don't worry, Xylie. No one's going to think he's a pedophile because it's obvious it's a joke. And if you don't understand that, then it's your fault.
It's really gross, but it's not pedophilia. He's not legally doing anything wrong.
So that's like an example of, like, people were like, well, why isn't Tipster, like, calling this out? Because she called Keemstar a pedophile.
No, she literally said that Keemstar was dating 16-year-olds. That's what she said. She said Keemstar was dating 16-year-olds. That's what she said. And do you know people actually fucking believe that?
Mm-hmm.
People actually fucking believe that.
And it's like, I don't dictate what Keffel says. She's her own person.
Yeah. When Keffel's consistently, like, makes over-exaggerations about what she thinks about people to the point of labeling them in that way, and then people think that she's out to get everybody, isn't that a fair assessment? Like,
who am I out to get?
Everyone in the commentary.
Start by calling him a pedo? Isn't that a fair assessment for someone to make based on looking at that tweet?
I'm not the first person to call him that.
That doesn't matter, bitch. You still called him that. Oh, no. See, we can't continue this. We can't. Because I'm going to end up breaking a keyboard or something. You know what I need?
What do you need?
I need chicken egg rolls. That's what I need. Chicken egg rolls. That's what I need.
Because I don't want to get me a part where he talks about the lolly again.
And how that was fine.
I was asking. It's your stream.
I am okay. Far from the person to say that. Like, I'm not going to like ruin his life or end his career by calling him something he's been getting called for a decade.
I also don't think it's fair to like make a big deal about when she says it, because like there's definitely been cases where people in the commentary community have jokingly called people pedophiles. Oh. And it's whatever. It's just kind of seen for what it is. It's a joke. Like, I can't remember who it was, but I want to say like 2 years ago there was somebody that Augie called a pedophile when he got really mad in an argument against him. I don't remember who that person was. It was like some like little tryhard small commentator, right? But to act like Keffels is the only one throwing around pedophile as a joke is pretty dishonest, because a lot of people do that.
I think this is
I never said that. I just said that like it's reasonable to think she's out to get people when she's labeling them like transphobes and pedophiles. I do think
it's kind of weird though to be like, oh man, Keffels. Like,
I'm gonna be honest. I don't like the pedophile jokes either. And Skip reminded me in the last live stream on the broadcast that Keemstar went on. He was joking about Tipster being a pedophile. He was being Keemstar, right? He's being all Keemstar. I don't think that's a joke. I don't think you should joke around and call people pedophile. You know what I'm saying? I don't think that's a joke, because that could be life ruining. You know?
And Tipster knows that. And what did he do after this live stream? Went on and insinuated that man's a pedo. But it's just jokes.
And it's like, well, you guys have done it too as a joke. I mean, when the lolly shit was happening, there were jokes made that insinuated I was a pedophile, and like people from the audience came away from that thinking that I was a pedophile who like consumes lolicon.
Well, when Keffels just called me a transphobe this morning,
this is what I try
to
explain to Augie. This is what I try to explain to Augie. Sometimes when you guys joke about stuff, the dipshits in the audience don't get that it's a joke. And so, like, with that situation, they made a bunch of jokes about me defending lolicon and shit like that. And so the audience came away from that thinking I was a lolicon and a pedophile.
Okay. But
you could see why that situation, like, I'm just going to be real. Because when I had the conversation with Augie, I was trying to keep things cordial. I was trying to go my own way, but also keep things, like, we weren't leaving on bad terms. But I'm just going to be real. That's why the whole leaving the commentary community thing, that was the bridge burner for me. Because I'm like, okay, maybe you guys were joking, but the audience came away from that thinking I was a fucking pedophile.
No, the audience did not. The audience did not. They, oh God. I mean, okay. Do I think it was wrong they were meaning it? 100%. I do. I think they were wrong for meaning it. I still to this day honestly believe that she did not accidentally hit that. She did not accidentally like that post. I do not think she did. But we can only go by her word. I think they were memeing that, and I didn't like that because I don't think Tipster is. All right? I'm not going to sit here and call him that. But he's done the same shit.
Hmm. Rules for thee, but not for me.
Yeah. That was the bridge burner for me. That's why I decided I'm done.
Same, Steffi.
So now you guys don't have to question it anymore. Now you just know.
Yeah, well, if anyone calls you a pedo, I'll go out of my way to say, hey, Tip's not a pedo, chill. But,
yeah, same.
So I haven't seen that. But, like, you say like, oh, well, Keffels makes jokes about pedos too. Was Keffels calling me a transphobe today a joke? Didn't seem like it.
I didn't make it as a joke.
Right there.
It wasn't a joke.
It wasn't no spoof. She went around saying, this is transphobic. You're promoting transphobia. That's also something that could damage somebody's reputation.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, it really can. It really can.
Especially if you're like Chris believes, a trans icon like Keffels.
Hold on. Rose, or have a good night, Rose. Or Rosa, excuse me.
Like, when people see those types of tweets and then say you're trying to like go after people and ruin them, isn't that like a fair assessment based on the tweet you made today about me?
No, I don't think so. Like, I don't think that saying that automatically means that you're getting ruined or that I want to ruin.
I never said that Leon isn't black anymore. Ooh.
No damn white man gonna be telling me that.
I know that's right.
You know what? Shackles coming off. Shackles coming off.
All right. Shackles off.
Ain't no white man pretending to be a cop gonna silence me.
I know that's George Floyd.
You ain't putting your knee on my neck.
I know that's right.
You racist just like Jay. What is this? What is that?
What? Oh.
I don't know if I'm supposed to be seeing that.
You're not.
I don't know if... Oh, well.
It's all right. It doesn't matter. It wasn't bad. Oh, my God. I have, like, DMs everywhere. Holy shit. Okay, send this photo. Oh, Squatchin sent me the photo. Okay. Let me go over here. What did Chris send me? Oh, Chris sent me the same photo. What did Eva?
I want a photo. No, I don't. I don't even know what that was about.
Okay, can you... Okay, I know you're going to hate doing this because you hate them so much. Okay? But can you talk to the chat while I go grab me a drink and run to the restroom?
Fine.
Okay,
please, I'll engage these marauders.
Okay, please talk nicely.
Hello, everyone. It's the Leon time. Here to let you all know that I hate you all, but I can't be mean about it, so I'll just calmly say, I hope you all buy food and it falls on the floor. You know, I think that's the right punishment. I hope there's no wet floor sign when you go to the bathroom and you fall on piss and shit. I hope when you go to the store and you have your little $5 off coupon for an air fryer, the coupon is expired, you know? I hope a dog bites you in your ass and the owner of it laughs at you. I hope when you go to McDonald's expecting to get something off the dollar menu, it's $5. That's all I got. Oh, man. What time is it? It's fucking 2 a.m. Ugh. Jesus, that's horror. What the fuck is horror? I hope a child with a razor scooter hits you in your fucking shin. Motherfucker said, I hope your favorite hoodie burns and your bonnet goes with it. Good luck with that. Gotta have me around fire, sister. Leon, what's your favorite animal? See, that's why I hate this chat. Y'all ask questions. Y'all need to be asking like a 5-year-old girl. Like, you don't ask a grown man, what's your favorite animal? Like, are you 5? Do you have a dent in your head? Like, what's wrong with you? What? Are you bored? Are you confused with yourself?
Wait, like, why are you talking about dents in the head? Who are you talking to? Who are you talking to?
Somebody just asked me randomly, what's your favorite animal? And it's just like, what?
Verse, be nice. Matt Pitt wants to know, who's your favorite black person?
Me.
I could have told you that. I could have answered that for him. I was going to say, I know it's going to be you.
Hey, me. I'm just like Keffles. I'm the only black person I see in this world.
All right, what's your favorite animal? Leon.
I'm choosing to ignore. You're engaging in this malarkey with them. I do not appreciate it. I swear to God, Xylie, one day you're coming on my stream and you can say whatever the fuck you want.
I would be the same in your stream. It's not like I would go mask off because I was on your
stream. Oh, please. I was there when you were there when that one person kept coming on the stream and they were just talking about nonsense.
Oh, my God. You talking about the chick?
Yeah.
Oh, my God. I wanted to go up there so bad, but I couldn't get up there fast enough. That fucking bitch. Oh, I wanted to cuss her ass out. I was about to embarrass her. Well, her conspiracy. I swear to God you saw the tinfoil underneath her hair. I swear to God. She drove me nuts.
I think the next stream I did, or like one of the streams I did recently, I was like, don't come in here talking about the Little Mermaid movie. Don't come in here talking about this, this, that, and the third. We was here to talk about, I think, a woman trying to kill her husband like four times. I don't know. It was something.
I wanted to read her the riot act because she was fucking crazy.
Leon, what's your favorite drug? You know, I do like a woman's clitoris. That is a drug to me. So
thank you, Beavers. You know what? Beavers, I will say, for being an asshole, I think it's really funny about saying that. Sorry, I'm eating a chocolate chip cookie.
I thought you was about...
Sorry. Okay.
I thought you was about to say something else.
Beavers, for being the asshole that he is, right? When now recording was going over the tipster shit, and he goes, you know you done fucked up, because look at the number one right here. And he called me the number one tipster simp, right? And I went up there, and I was like, I was still seething. I was so angry. I was shaking, right? And I went up there, and he was like, I will no longer call you a tipster simp anymore. And I was like, thank you. And he hasn't. He hasn't. He kept his word. I thought that was really sweet. Because I was so mad that night. Oh, my God. I was so angry. Beaver McWood, I'm the nicest guy in NR. Ugh, I don't know about that, dude. I don't know if you're the nicest one. Honestly, I mean, you're all kind of... Actually, no, you're not all nice. Matthew Pitt is an asshole. There, I said it. Matt Pitt is an asshole. The rest of you are nice to me. Yes, Beaver, you are 100% correct. Matt is the least nice one. 100%. Everybody else is nice to me. And Burse is my baby. I love me some Burse. I do love me some Burse. Even though he's not part of Now Recording, I was talking about Now Recording, but... The fuck did I do to you? Matthew.
Chris is offering me a dick pic.
Who?
Chris. Because you remember when...
Why? You know
I was talking
small.
About photos... That's tough. You remember when I was talking about photos? He just fucking randomly DM'd me. He's like, I'll send you a photo.
Chris is
offering me dick pics.
I don't know why Chris don't jump on this call, because I know he was in the Discord playing Minecraft.
And I swear to God, if you send me a dick pic, I'm sending you EDP's penis. I didn't want to see... who the fuck is this? Bunny? I don't want to fucking see this shit. So you better block my fucking DM, bitch.
He hasn't been on Minecraft today? Oh. No, but Matt is always bullying me.
Is like, this your co-host?
Who?
Bunny?
B-U-N-N-I?
I guess, yes.
Yeah, but where is she? Is she in here?
No, it's fucking... He sent me a tweet of her in a chair... in lingerie. And it's like, I don't want to see this.
Oh, yeah, that's Bunny. That's my co-host on, broadcast.
Chris, you got to the count of five to get this out of my DMs. One. Two.
Wait, he said to send a photo, so you send a photo of my fucking co-host?
Four.
Chris, why
five.
Are you sending Leon?
You better get that out of there. You better get that out of there.
Chris, why are you sending a photo of my fucking co-host to Leon?
You better get that shit out of there, Chris.
Bro.
Because best believe I had that dick pic ready for you to see. I told Chris, don't fuck with me, I don't fuck with you.
No, Skelly, I'm not going over the 2B one last night. It was really good, though. I did watch it.
I'll go over it. The long and short is, the one, Augie... completely fucking owned them. That's all you need to know.
Agreed.
Why is Leon threatening me with EDP's dick? Because I don't want to fucking see no picture of some white woman.
Oh, look. It's my abuser.
Oh, fine. I'll just leave.
No, don't leave. I was joking.
you really are an abused person. This is like the mentality. No, no, baby, don't leave me.
Fuck you, Matt. Oh my God, you're such a dick, bro. I hate you. I hate you so much.
With a black eye, you're just like, you're like, I love him.
Oh God, I really was that person at one point in my life.
Okay, well, way to make that dark there, Xylie. Appreciate it.
It's okay. I can laugh about it now, man. It was so many years ago. I can laugh about it now. Shit.
Did you see the new Goth Mommy drama that popped up?
No. What's going on?
Fucking Ashley Cheerleader freaked out because she, I guess she realized she was on the list.
Okay.
And started freaking out and being like, take me off the list. I'm not, take me off the list now. Take me off. And then I was like, well, I'm going to find some tweets of you tweeting for tips. Oh, there they are. And I'm like, no, you're staying on the list. A, it's not real. B, it's not like, it doesn't, can't hurt you, but.
She had it in her bio.
Yeah, she had it in her bio, Tipster Cheerleader.
I screenshotted it and I fucking quote tweeted it. And she changed the bio. Changed the bio to Cheerleader for Everyone. At first, it was Tipster's Cheerleader. Now it's Cheerleader for Everyone.
So she blocked me, so I blocked her back.
Get pwned, stupid bitch.
Then she sends somebody to DM me being like, hey, she just wanted to say that she's sorry for overreacting, but she just wants to be X'd out because she lost a Tipster follower. I was like, okay.
So. Wait, she has the fucking Halloween Tipster as her fucking banner on.
That's what I thought it was. That's what it is, isn't it?
Idiot!
Wait, what? Oh.
You don't remember, like, the Tipster Halloween skeleton thing that he had?
Oh, yeah, that is Tipster. That's the hoodie I was going to buy with that one on it. Yeah.
She's a fucking idiot.
Bruh. And then she sent some person into my DMs being like, can you unblock her now? And I'm like, no. Absolutely not.
Damn. Oh, my God. You are such a fucking bully, Matt. I swear to God.
How am I being a bully? This is supposed to be fun. And these fucking women won't take it seriously. All right? They keep taking it seriously. Like, they think it's like some fucking Scarlet Letter or something. Like, calm the fuck down. I'm not Augie. I'm not going to call you a whore and a dumb bitch. And
I am, you dumbass bitch.
Like, fuck, calm that down.
Oh, my God. Oh man.
Can we got the Scarlet Letter females? We've been stamped with the letter G on our chest for Goth Mommy. What do we do?
Oh, big the fucks in the chat.
Holy shit, that's funny. Poor Ashley. Bless her heart. Oh, that's the Ashley, because somebody tried to give me... Okay, I think it was Chris tried to give me... I thought it was the other... I was thinking Asher's, because Asher's is the one that has me...
No, not Ashley. No, Asher's didn't even make the tier list.
Yeah.
But this is Ashley Cheerleader.
Yeah. She's nice. I like her. Bless her heart.
She's... never interacted with her.
She's always been nice to me on Twitter.
Take me off the list, man.
Well, you know people got upset about that goddamn list.
Yeah, but it's been like 3 weeks now, and I'm fucking marking people off the list. Now, and they still want to bitch about it, you know?
True.
Fucking off of me.
So what do you think about the two debates that happened?
The two debates that what do you mean?
Like the Bowblax Tipster... Kefles, oh yeah, and then the Augie.
Yeah. Well, the Augie one was great. I love the Augie one. The Bowblax one, Bowblax Tipster one was awkward and annoying because Tipster is a very Tipster is just a fucking white knight, bro. That's all he is. I mean, he's like, he just jumps on every fucking train, and he's just like, well, you know, Kefles didn't mean it like that. You know, Kefles got to do this. Blah 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 blah. It's just fucking annoying.
My question is, he's using the same defenses that he used with Bowblax and that BLM song and all the other shit that the guys do.
Yeah.
So, if they didn't mean it, and Kefles, why is it now it's Kefles didn't mean it like that, but you guys are wrong? You know what I mean? It's like he's completely flipping it. Just say nobody meant what they said and move on.
Dude, I know for a fact that Tipster, this all stems from Tipster being so butthurt and mad about stuff, but not having the guts to, like, bring it up and instead waiting and waiting and waiting and having it build and build and build. And then finally he decides to leave because he sees an opportunity with a bunch of trans women who can like create a community for him where he can be more comfortable, or like he can, like, he doesn't have to worry about being the butt of the joke every fucking day. There.
Well, mission failed. You gonna be the butt of the joke for probably the next week, and it's your own fucking fault.
The butt of the joke, dude. The way they do stuff, it's not the butt of the joke. It's the, like, the, it's like the butt of the complete fucking stomp that they'll do to you the when Buddhism. They realize that. Yeah.
I mean, I'm all for him leaving the community. If you're not happy in the community, then leave. Okay, I'm all for that. I was all for it when he was talking to me about it. Okay, I was all for him leaving. You know, if you're not happy in this community, yes, leave. But not the way that he did it, though.
Bro, just, like, just don't interact.
Yeah,
and stop.
Exactly.
The thing, like, don't interact and stop saying, oh, this is why I left. This is why I left. This is why I left. Like,
yeah.
Oh, you see what Tommy said? Yeah, that's the reason why. Yeah, I totally agree. With, like, he copies Tommy's, like, talking points all the time. He steals his shit. And, like, when Tommy makes a decent point against something that Tipster wanted to do but couldn't like, deliver, Tommy actually makes the point and makes it a little more sense, and he just takes it.
Yeah.
And he's just like, no, that's exactly what I meant.
Yeah. I don't know, dude. It's all fucking sad. I mean, I'm so fucking disappointed in the dude. I really am. I'm angry and I'm disappointed. I don't know which one I am more, though, to be honest with you. Like, it's easier for me to show disappointment than it is anger, just as normally as a person. And sometimes my disappointment comes out as anger when it's really disappointment. And I just can't tell if it's more disappointment that I have for him or anger, because I'm kind of feeling both, I'm not going to lie. I feel like he slapped me in the face with that fucking joke, dude. And then seeing Keffels can be edgy. Keffels can make these edgy jokes. Keffels can say this and that, but yet, you know, my once friends can't do it anymore. But they could do it when we were friends, though. You know? I don't get it. I really don't get it. You know, it's sad. Mm. It's fucking ridiculous.
I love it, Lamau.
You love what?
All the stupidity coming from Tipster. Because now he got to live with it. It can't be a thing of, well, I was misjudged. No, you stood by, you defended it, you gaslit, you tried to make jokes that failed. Like, no, now you got to live with it. Live with the hypocrisy. Live with looking like a dumbass. I hope it's worth it.
I really do believe he's doing all this because look how many times he, quote unquote, left the community but came back, right?
Yeah.
I think he's burning the bridges on purpose so he can't come back. I really do. I really do. I think he's burning the bridges.
He's gonna hear you say that and that's what he's gonna say. I guarantee you. That's what he does.
Well,
right?
Guess what, bitch? I said it first.
Like, he's about, oh, no, yeah, I was burning the bridges because I just didn't want to come back, and I was trying. Like, whenever, like, the fall from Keffels happens or something, he's going to come back and be like, yeah, I just wanted to destroy all of our relationships because I didn't want you to accept me back again because he kept accepting me back. He's going to pull a boogie. Like, I just keep fucking up, guys. I'm a piece of shit.
Do you think he's going to try to come back?
If Keffels and them, like, shit on him, yeah. I don't know if that'll happen, but... Like, where else would he go?
He can go off and do his own thing.
Turn
he
off
needs
the fucking computer.
People around him, bro. He needs a community. He needs, like, an ecosystem to thrive.
Yeah. I don't know. It's stupid. It's all fucking stupid. He is just being... I can't stand Keffels. I cannot stand her.
Like, Tipster is addicted to defending other people, but not because he's a good friend, because he enjoys, like, the camaraderie of, oh, those guys got my back, I'll have their back, and when they get my back, they can praise me. But eventually what started to happen was he would defend them, but the way he would defend them or the way he would defend something else would make him look really stupid, And so his friends were like, wow, that was kind of stupid, Tipster. What the fuck are you doing?
Yeah.
You're showing way too emotion in this. And then he would start to be like, they don't defend me the way I defend them. And he started sulking. And it just started building.
That was kind of funny when Augie pulled in Leafy and they just dipped out.
Dylee, if you want to laugh, look at your Discord DMs.
Look at my Discord DMs. Damn right. That's that stupid bitch. Fuck yes. Look at that ugly bitch. Look at that pearly things bitch. That is her. I'm going to tweet that shit out. I'm going to tweet that shit out. Maybe. I don't know. I did my bad tweet the other day with Keffels. I feel kind of guilty for that one. Not going to lie. But oh well, I did it. Shit. Oh, I can't see my chat. Yep. It's all done. Tippy Lolcast. Commentary Lolcast. Tipster, Keffels, and... Okay, first of all, Keffels isn't commentary community, so let's not do that.
Did you hear Flamingo came back while y'all were streaming?
No, what happened?
On Bowblax's stream, Flamingo came on Bowblax's stream and argued with Nicholas DiOrio and called him the N-word.
Wait, what?
Based, LOL.
Yeah.
Wait, and I'm just now learning about this?
Yeah, as while y'all were
saying
streaming.
That in the chat.
Oh, I didn't pay attention. What?
That was when Bowblax raided.
Oh.
Yeah, it's like they were all like Flamingo came on to argue with Lyrics and Aiden, and then Nick popped in and they started arguing about random shit, and just Flamingo calls him the N-word and like all this. It was weird.
Oh my god. I'm gonna have to go back and watch that. He better have that up. Aiden
yeah,
got
bots,
him
though.
To admit the Shota stuff is 100% real.
Yeah.
Yeah,
no! I think Xylie's mic peaked.
No, did he really?
Yeah, I mean, he got him to admit that, yeah, he downloaded it, basically. He downloaded it and made... did he get him to admit that he read it? Can't remember.
Wow. Yeah, I'm going to have to go back and watch that. Damn. So now Flam is, like, really back now.
I mean, I guess. I don't think he can just... He can't just come back and, like, not talk about it, so...
The only time that... Flamingo is going to be following around Nicholas DiOrio until... He or Nicholas DiOrio dies, whatever happens first. So, like, 40 years from now, Flam is still going to be talking about Nick.
Yeah. That Nicholas DiOrio is so fat.
Oh, my God.
He's not a pedo, but he would eat a child.
He called Nick the F-slur, what, 37 times? Oh, my God.
Yeah.
Nicholas DiOrio.
It was a year ago, bro. It was a year ago when this shit went down. And he's still fucking angry about it. And he's mad. The thing, the arguments with Nick, though, is he thinks Nick began having a grudge with Flamingo because Flamingo called him the F-slur on the technical stream, like, back in November of 2021. And Nick's like, what the fuck are you talking about? You think that's how it started? And he's like, well, yeah, I think that's how it started, buddy. And Nick kind of just laughed because it made no sense.
Oh, my God. Matt Pitt, say double stuffed in your old man voice.
Okay, buddy, double stuffed.
Oh, my God. Squatch.
Double stuffed DiOrio. Oh, God. I remember him. It was 45 years ago. We were on Discord together. And that son of a bitch would not stop calling me a pedophile.
Oh, my God. Hey, when is your next episode of Now Recording coming out?
I got it scheduled for the 19th, I think. Wait, okay. No. No, the 16th, I think. Maybe. I don't, or 15th or either tomorrow, 15th, 15th or 16th.
Verse, yes, he did sound like he needed to take a shit. He absolutely did. Yeah, because y'all go live tomorrow night, right?
Mm-hmm.
11?
Yeah, 11 o'clock.
Okay, yeah, because I'm taking the next 2 days off because I need to go through and I did verify that screenshot to see if it was in the that screenshot you gave me. I verified it and saw it in the video. She definitely showed it in the video plain as day. So I took a screenshot of the actual video where you see my YouTube shit on the side of it and everything, that it was legit in that video. 100%. I was like, uh-huh. You dumb bitch.
Dude, this heart thing on the corner of the chat sucks. I can't read it, and I gotta wait for someone else to
yes!
say something.
Yes, I hate that goddamn heart all thing, right. Because if you go to, like, do any kind of, like, say it was a bad comment that needed to be taken away, you can't do shit until somebody says something else. So you can click
it. Skeletalk says, which is the higher chance of getting on now recording, Leafy or Flamenco? Probably Flamenco. I don't see any way of me having a conversation with Leafy, and I don't know if I want to.
Really?
Yeah, I mean, like, I was never, I got into commentary really late. I was never, like, a big Leafy guy, so I don't really see him as, like, the big creator for who was, like, a legend, right? I just see him as this guy who did YouTube videos. So, like, I'm not excited to, like, ask him questions.
Yeah.
I'd probably rather have Flamingo. Nothing against Leafy. He's just, like, I wouldn't know what to really ask him.
I'm not a big Leafy fan, my damn self.
I would probably rely on, like, D-Max or someone else to, like, or Beavers or someone like that to the question.
Hey, speaking of alt-right platforms, I am at now 1.64K on Rumble.
Congrats.
Bro, I don't know where all these people are coming from, but I am.
How are you doing on Cozy?
Yes, smartass. I'm not on Cozy, you asshole. I would never go on Cozy, ever. Ever, ever, ever.
Stan, I would not know. I don't want to get Femios on and have, like, a transgender debate. I don't want anything really to do with that debate. Like, I had Jalen on, like, Max mostly talked about it with him, but or her. But I'm in my 30s, and this shit's kind of just weird to me. Not weird as in horrible, but weird as in just really different. I don't really have an opinion on any of it. Like, I don't want to get in some debate with a transgendered 18-year-old who thinks they own the world, you know?
I mean, I get that. It's like me not really wanting to talk about, like, I don't like talking about the, like, children transitioning or anything. I don't have a child, and mm-hmm. I think it boils down to what the parent and the child want
yeah,
to do.
Like,
I'm not
yeah,
going to tell
like
parents
never...
how to parent their child, so I don't...
Yeah.
I don't feel like I'm equipped to have that conversation. You know?
Like, I will never be in that position to have to decide about transitioning my child, so I don't
right.
have to worry about it.
Right, exactly. And I because I'm definitely, you have a chance. Me, I definitely don't have a chance to be in that position, and it's just something that I'm not equipped to have, one, because I'm not, like, very educated on it, like, to the T, and two, I don't have a kid, so I don't know what it's like to have a child and have stuff like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I don't, that position, I've never been in that position. Okay,
yeah.
Chris, can you please stop dropping links in the chat? That would be great. I would
Chris
appreciate
doesn't
it.
Understand that this is not his, I say we ban Chris.
What, ban him?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Fuck.
Oh, what? Chris is a bitch. Did you message retracted? What a bitch, Chris.
He don't even stand on his own.
Got
I'm sorry, Xylie.
Got
I'm sorry,
him.
Xylie. I'll delete it.
Wait, Leon can't ban you.
Oh, you better be lucky I can't. Ain't no daring me, because
oh,
I do
look,
it.
Look, it's a slug rate. Slug, why do you keep raiding me? I won't let
well,
you in.
Well, Chris, I can't ban you, but I can do this.
You know, to save Maggot, I had to put her as a moderating mod.
You gave her too much power.
Steffi, Slug can't even type on here. He's already been banned from the chat. he's pulling an alpha move, going, yeah, you might have me banned, but I'll still raid your chat.
Ain't Buddy like a weirdo?
Who?
This slug. Ain't he like a weirdo?
Well...
Yeah, let's just keep it like that. Yeah, sure. Yeah.
I don't
want to go into the...
I don't really have in-depth knowledge about any of you people. All I get is the random side comment.
Yeah, like you're the one-legged guy.
Well, if you want information on these type of people, you can check out Now Reporting on the Now Reporting channel.
Yuck, self-promo.
It's okay. He's allowed to. You should see when somebody gives me, like, a big tip or something. He's like, hey, by the way, we stream on Wednesday nights at 11 p.m.
I stream every once in a while. I don't know where I stream. Fuck. I just press the button.
I know that's right.
Yo, Skelly, like, I get what you're saying, but at the same point, like, if you want me to have Tommy on with Leapy, why not have just Leapy come on Shopping Point? You know what I mean? Like, I think that would be better. That would be more fun, in my opinion.
I think so, too. I agree with that. Leafy on Shot from the Point, that actually would be a good episode, probably.
Yeah.
I'm going to call into one of Leafy's streams and telling him about Now Recording. Okay, Skelly.
I got Chris putting timed out. I'm proud of myself.
Do you feel good about that?
Yeah. Fuck Chris.
Yeah, fuck that cop.
Fake ass wannabe George Floyd killer.
You stupid. I hate you so much right now. I swear to God.
That's fine.
Okay, let me pull this up. No, asshole. Okay, there we go.
Oh, yeah. I'm glad you just said that about me, Xylie. I got a bone to pick with you.
Oh, my God. What?
It is so petty, and I'm acknowledging it's petty before I even say it.
Okay.
When I called whoever that was dude, it was just to call him dude. And it wasn't even like, oh, I think Xylie's calling me transphobic. It's like, no, I just called it dude.
Wait, what are you talking about?
Wait, I forgot.
When we was watching whoever that was, like,
Kepples?
3 days ago. No.
Baby, you've already explained this to me.
I did?
Yeah.
I'm drunk.
Okay. Makes sense.
You called a trans person a dude? I think I remember this. I feel like I remember something.
Call everybody dude.
Yeah, he calls everybody fuck dude. Yeah. No, you already explained it, baby.
Who was the person?
I did?
Yeah.
Well, damn it, I'm going to explain it again. Like,
who was the person that you called dude?
I don't remember. I don't remember.
It's some fat white woman? Because you was talking about somebody who sent panties to... somebody named Adam.
Oh, it was Cody. Cody Rance. Cody Rance.
Oh.
I call everybody.
I'm sorry,
dude.
Jussie what? What, Jussie?
Jussie Smollett?
Juicy. Hey, Juicy. Guess what? You got 5 minutes to think about that, Juicy. Yeah, I said your name wrong. Juicy. Juicy, juicy. Anybody else want to say something wrong? I'll hide your ass. Well, not hide. I'll time your ass out, too. And the next time you can come back
you
in.
Said you were a dude?
Ain't nothing wrong with being called a dude.
Yeah. You never heard the, I'm a dude.
She's a dude. Y'all don't never fucking. That's why I know I'm fucking old. I got shit that's supposed to unite the world as my speech. And you motherfuckers call it hateful.
Look, Maggot got a hold of Echo. Wait, everybody's getting timed out tonight. Whoops. Wait, did you you didn't hide Echo, right? I mean, Echo's an asshole, but you didn't hide Echo, right?
I wish I could hide plants. Fuck plants.
Listen, okay, Echo's not hidden. Echo was just putting time out. Leave plants alone.
No.
Plants is a protected class in this chat, okay?
A baloney loving white supremacist. Anybody who likes baloney, you're racist, you're transphobic, you're probably Hitler's descendant. How dare.
Oh,
somebody
banned
Chris again.
Bonnie said justice for plants. Leon has baloney brain. Ooh. Did you do that?
What?
Maggot did it.
No, I didn't do it.
Oh, Maggot did it?
I love it. Y'all, do my bidding.
God.
We will not have supremacy in this chat tonight.
Maggot's like, I'm getting them all. I got shooters everywhere. Bang, bang. What have I missed the last 3 days? Wow.
I'll sum it up.
Mitch, bullshit. Mitch, I have a really good video idea for you that will get you lots and lots of views, sir. FYI. But it's going to have to take you doing some research.
Get Chris's bitch ass in here. And
he won't come in here. He won't call into my shows anymore. Ever since fucking Keemstar show, he won't call in here anymore. He's a bitch.
Wait, scared of Keem?
Yes.
You scared of Keem, bitch? You scared of that
beard?
Ever
since Keemstar show, and they used to give him shit for calling into my shows, he has not called in. And I'm being serious. Yes.
I actually come across a lot of weird content I want to send Leon, but he hasn't DM'd me.
Motherfucker,
you're not special.
Xylie is making up lies. Oh no, don't retract the message, motherfucker, because I fucking read it.
Bro, I DM nobody.
Keep retracting. Why are you a bitch?
Chris the retractor.
Yep, Chris the retractor.
Chris the bitch.
That dude.
He is. So I got these new vapes. They look like little slushy cups with a straw.
That's a big-ass vape, huh?
Mm-hmm. Well, no, they're little. I mean, they still hold in your hand. It's not like an actual cup, but they're shaped like cups, like slushy cups with a straw on top. And I have peach mango watermelon and pear cotton candy, and they are really good.
I'm about to say, that ain't a vape. That's a hookah at that point.
Night, Maggot. Chris the retracted. Damn right I see everything.
He got timed out again.
Who timed him out?
Maggot. That's why the motherfuckers like bye.
Oh, Maggot. Poor Maggot. I'm gonna have to make her a regular mod again. Maggot, don't abuse your power because you know what happened last time.
Fuck it. Abuse your power so I can get it.
Matt got
your ass. Abuse your power so I can get it. I'm going to start banning you motherfuckers from out of here.
Stripes,
we're
going to
clean up this chat.
Try aloe grape vape flavor. It's so good. Aloe grape? I don't like grape,
aloe
though.
Piss?
Oh, stop it. I knew you were going to say that because I was thinking it. Okami, Maggot deleted for calling your eyes being old. Oh, calling my ass being old? Well, fuck him then. Fuck him. Did Chris call me old?
No, he said your eyes were old.
My eyes were old. He called you. It's all right. I see Chris right just back about every day in the same Discord call. I will get his ass.
Don't Chris, you a grown ass man. You need to defend yourself, pussy.
He ain't gonna defend himself. He's scared. He should be scared. He ain't gonna come up here. What?
Was I a good little slave today? Did I say any profanity that would keep you from keeping the stream up?
Okay, one, I would never call you a slave, okay? I would never, never disrespect a black man by calling him a slave, all right? But were you a good noodle? Yes, you were.
All right, can I be a degen now?
Yes.
I don't know who, well, never mind. Anybody who knows Nick DiOrio, somebody tell him that I don't care that he said the F slur while I was streaming. Like, I feel like he genuinely felt bad that he said that while I was streaming.
Wait, when did he say that? When were you on stream with Nick?
That would have been by now, 2 days ago.
Did he call into your stream?
No, I was streaming with Chris, and we were in Chris's Discord, and he joined that.
Oh.
And while he was talking about, I think, Tipster, he just said it. And I was like, yo, but I didn't care.
Okay. All right.
And I wasn't banned for him saying it, so.
I'll tell him, or I'm sure Chris is going to run and tell him. Somebody will tell him. One of us will.
I didn't get banned for it, so.
Good.
Hooray for homophobia.
Are you going to stick with Twitch?
I'm just streaming everywhere. I don't care.
I got to start streaming over at,
I'm restreaming everywhere. I don't know how to, because the restream thing doesn't have a ability to connect to Rumble, which is annoying.
There's got to be a way to do it, because I know Augie has streamed on YouTube and Rumble at the same time.
I swear. I don't think it's with Restream, though, so I guess there's another.
Maybe there is. I don't know. But I was going to do a couple of days, but I keep forgetting to set it up so I can do it. I need to upload another Mr. Girl video on my Rumble. I'll probably do it tomorrow.
Leon was streaming on, like, three things. Yeah, that's what the fuck. That's the whole point of Restream, is like be able to stream on different platforms.
Yeah, Rennie, stop being such an elitist. What?
Oh, and I blame you for this, Xylie. I made a coffee.
Okay, and what are you blaming me for?
Because it's how I phrase my sentences.
Before you go, you have to play the Femme. No, I don't. Not going to. Say,
she's not going to.
I'm not going to, Stan. I've already said I'm not going to. Oh, I'll see, as I'm falling notes. Asleep, I need to make coffee. Rennie, you need to go to bed. That's what you need to do.
Right, it's against TOS for affiliates and partners to restream old platforms.
Welcome back, Matt.
Stupid ass. That I should have been banned then. The fuck? You know, I've been multi-streaming for months as an affiliate. They ain't gonna fucking touch me.
Okami, I will always talk about Pearly Things. I'm pretty sure I'm gonna find something else to talk about with Pearly Things. I can't stand that chick. And by the way, Matthew, yes, you've been A-logging Tipster, and no, I do not go ree every time Mr. Girl does something.
No, this is what you do. Every time, like, Mr. Girl does something crazy, you're just like, uh-uh. Nuh-uh. Uh-uh.
That's tough.
Oh,
Xylie.
Hell no. That's your A-logging.
That's tough, Xylie.
Fuck you.
That's tough, Xylie. Fuck you. He ain't wrong, Xylie.
Shut up. Shut the fuck up, Leon. God damn it. You don't know me. You don't know me.
I don't know you, but he do.
He don't know me either. He thinks he knows me, goddamn.
He kind of read you like a book, just not.
He did, but we ain't talking about that, okay? We ain't gonna talk about that. God damn it. I still didn't read your whole thread on Tipster. I just know you were saying a bunch of things on there. I was like, what the fuck is this? And I'm like, 1, 2, 3. I was like, god damn.
Yeah, I was watching the stream, and I was just like, I was basically just role-playing as Tipster. So, anyone want to place any bets on who the next goth mommy will leave?
All right, let's look.
Oh, that was your fucking tweet, because you had tweeted that fucking picture of that tier list. Yeah. And Saggy was just like, I don't understand why everyone's having such an issue. I'm still friends with Tipster. Nobody fucking asked.
Well, that's Saggy.
Nobody cared.
This must be about me.
Okay. Who is the next one we think's going to leave? Well, who is this person here?
You gotta share your screen or something. I don't know who this person is.
Oh, shit. My bad. Hold on.
Which one?
Okay. Who is this person?
That is Mari. Oh, by the way, the Ashley girl has been X'd out as well. I put out another update.
Okay. X! X! Alright. Who is that?
Hold on. Your thing's blurry. What were you? Move your mouse around. Oh, there we go. That is Horror Hellfire. Or THS.
Who is that?
Kitten Fantastic.
Oh, well, she ain't even around to be kicked off.
Yeah, but she was, like, I gotta say, like, she was, I think she was the most, she did the most work for Tipster.
Yeah. True. What's up, Doug?
Bro, if you ever need a bot to like kick people out of Discord servers, she's your girl.
Really?
Yeah.
I say the next one to go, truthfully. It's gonna be between Jessica and Rum.
Really?
Yes.
Wow, that's. I see. I would expect Rum to hold on as long as possible.
Not until it, I think Rum will succumb to pressure. Because
the thing is, though, like no one in this community like really cares for Rum, right? Because they all think she liked the lolly and yada yada yada.
Mm-hmm.
So like, I think that gives her more excuse to stay.
Well, a lot of people didn't care for Rum before that, so.
Yeah, true, but like a lot of people didn't know who Rum was before that. When I like the Augie circle didn't really know who she was.
True. Yeah, I think it's gonna be between Jessica and Rum.
I want to know something interesting about Mari. Mari was like still faithful to Flamenco for the longest time. Modern Flamenco server could still be a modern Flamenco server for all I know. So I don't know how close she is to Tipster now. That's the question, right?
Right.
So, I would probably say, I would probably go with Mari. Mari or Ginger?
You think so? Mario Baker?
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
And I hope, Empress, I hope everything's okay with Rum. I mean, I don't want bad things to happen to her, of course. Yeah.
Ginger doesn't really have a dog in the race, so I could probably see her being like, all right, this is a bit much. Bye, guy. Yeah.
Bonnie's thinking Ginger or Jessica. I think Jessica's one of the ones that's going to go next. Because here's the thing about Jessica. Jessica will sit there and I think Jessica is going to start comparing and start like, okay, but you're saying this, but this is what you did. You're saying this, but this is what you did. Because she remembers everything. She's almost like a fucking encyclopedia.
Mm-hmm.
Honestly. So. Yeah, I think between me personally, I think Jessica or Rum. Bonnie thinks Jessica or Ginger. People are saying Jessica. Empress says Rum or Hellfire. And Jessica. So by popular demand, it's probably Jessica. Probably.
All the goth mommy gone.
Oh, they're not all
one
gone.
Five.
No.
I think all the major ones except for Rum and Zag are gone.
Yeah. True.
I'm not a goth mommy.
I'm not a goth mommy. That was so funny. I remember threatening y'all's lives going, if you put me on that list, I swear to God.
You should have put on that list just for threatening y'all.
I thought about it.
He almost did. That's how much of a dick he is.
You ain't gonna threaten me and think I'm gonna just do something.
Well, I threatened it. Wait, what did Ginger say? Disavow what he's doing and the path he's going on, but I don't hate him. Oh, it has nothing to do with hate. You don't have to hate him. That's all about how I have to say. Okay.
You gotta turn your back on him.
Eva said, be funny if it was Keffels. True. True. That's eventually going to happen, though. I guarantee it. I guarantee that's going to happen. All right, well, I'm going to get out of here. Thank you for coming on. Y'all have a great night. I'm going to
adios.
Play us out. Peace out. Bye, Leon.
Ooh, me?
Yes, I'm leaving.
Oh, where you going?
Going to bed.
Damn. You know? Leon whisper sweet nothings to chat again before you go. All right. Xylie, can I?
Yes, go ahead.
Fuck you all.
And he says that with love.
No. Drastic hatred. Like I told y'all, I hope y'all go to McDonald's looking for something off the dollar menu, and it's $5.
You know what? Goodbye. My God. Yes, we definitely have an aunt and nephew like relationship. All right, guys, you know what? This stream was all about friends, and we're going to end it with friends.
Job's a joke, you broke, your love life's DOA. It's like you're always stuck in second gear. When it hasn't been your day, your week, your month, or even your year, but I'll be there for you. I'll be there for you. I'll be there for you. Cause you're there for me, get to.
See that, Steffi? Tipster used to say that.